Here we go. Are you guys ready? Let me make sure volume is good. Turn it up a little bit.
Ladies and gentlemen and travelers of all kinds.
Even with the trivia right away.
The fabulous fox, Yai Miko, the one, the
loud
only,
enough? Question mark?
Ratna.
Oh, thank you so much. You're too kind. Now for almost
I love when
years,
they do this.
We've explored every corner of Teyvat, uncovering stories of all kinds.
To bring the voice actors into it.
We've prepared a little game show where you are the contestant.
Ah!
Now I know what you're thinking.
I'm scared.
Ratna, is this just an excuse for you and your friends to geek out about Genshin Impact lore?
And that's actually not what I'm thinking. I'm gonna fail.
I need an excuse? Anyway, here's the first question.
Mm-hmm.
According to A, what could have been used to bribe Yai Miko?
Oh, I don't remember!
A, new books. Shampoo to keep her tail and ears fluffy. C, rare fabrics and silk. D, fried tofu.
I'm gonna say either A or C. Don't make me pick,
the
I won't.
The answer is D.
Dang, I got it wrong.
Okay, if you got that one right, pat yourself on the back. If not, there'll be other chances.
Oh,
now, I need to get Josie ready for the next
off.
Round, but I'll see you soon. Good luck, travelers.
Dang.
Hey, Josie Montana McCoy here.
Gaia!
Ready for round two?
We said the same things,
that
really.
Kind of serious in that intro, huh?
Okay, well, that makes me feel a little bit better.
I don't want to be the one to disappoint her. Question: what does the Court of Fontaine legally consider Paimon to be?
A flying object.
A personal assistant. B, an endangered species. C, a balloon.
Oh, it's a balloon.
D,
it's a balloon.
Cultural delicacy.
It's a balloon. Farina called her a flying object for the law. She's a balloon.
C, a balloon.
Yes, I got one right.
I heard that for the very steep price of one sticky honey roast, Paimon will join your hometown parade.
Wow.
Whatever.
I don't want her
hey
to.
Everyone. Paul Castro Jr. here, voice of Frem.
Hi, Josh. Welcome back.
And
how are
it's
you?
It's my privilege to Frem. Welcome you to this latest round of Teyvat Trivia.
Yay.
Speaking of welcomes, what warm welcome did the House of the Hearth give to the Traveler and Paimon? A, cosplaying as Paimon. Imitation is the highest form of flattery. B, presenting them with a captured hilly churl rogue. C, a crash course on espionage and poison brewing.
Yeah, that.
D, a traditional
yeah, C.
dance.
C. Lenny argued her to beat a balloon to save us. Right. Okay. I remember now.
I don't know about you guys, but my personal poison is kombucha, and I've never.
Thank you for the look, effortless.
I need to try one day, though.
Hope right, you're doing
that's
well.
That's all for this round, and remember, never store your poisons in an old soda bottle.
Aw, oh, dang. I do that all the time. What do you mean?
Caleb, you're Gami.
Gami!
Who's up for a little true or false?
Caleb!
True or false? When Kuching got her vision,
Caleb, our Gami and our Kalis.
Her newfound power.
Girl, I don't know. I'm gonna go...
False.
True. Oh.
Kuching actually took offense to the idea of needing a vision, so she tried to get rid of it. First by burning it,
that makes sense actually.
The minecart, and finally,
that checks out.
It from the Jade Chamber's roof. I mean, that's crazy, huh? What's that? Oh,
Kuching just standing on top of the Jade Chamber, like chucking it into the air, is
when it comes to dropping objects from
my new favorite thing.
Especially if said object shoots lightning. You know, if I had an electrovision, I'd probably like use it to make pancakes or something. Because then you wouldn't need to use like the stove, and it could just be like, oh, pancakes. Sorry. That's all for now, but there's more to come.
That's the most Caleb thing I've ever heard him say.
You get it? Remini? Okay, true or false? Everyone in Fontaine knows
you literally
the
have a pyrovision. What are you talking about?
The children of the Hydro Dragon.
True, yeah, I think. Well, no, false, because they...
False.
Yeah.
Melusines are the children.
Yeah,
of
because Nuvalette wanted to make sure that everyone knew that
stretch. They were born from
who they are, why they are
inside its corpse centuries ago. Now, me personally, I've never seen a corpse explosion birth, but I'm sure that's quite the sight to see. Yeah?
Oh.
Who would have thought such this would come from something so dark? But then again, the same could be said about our boy Fremini. Guess who's back? It's
oh
me,
my God.
Got a really good
I am so excited to see
yay
your reaction to everything. I am so tired from staying
hi,
up, but I enjoyed it nonetheless.
Thank you so much for the 100 bitties. I appreciate it. I hope you're doing well.
C, spa owner. D, fish tamer.
I genuinely don't know.
A,
Hey, maybe. Rapper. Oh, I was gonna go B.
Hey, my name is Yanfei.
Did she get inspired by Hu Tao?
That doesn't really rhyme. Yeah, I wouldn't pursue being a rapper.
Anyway, hey, love, what are you doing?
Think you can keep up?
Oh my god. Artis, welcome back. Hello, how are you?
The first three natives of Mondstadt to join the Traveler's Quest.
The first three natives? He's not a Mondstadt native. What are you talking about?
False. Kaya isn't actually a native to Mondstadt. He was born in Conria, but was abandoned in Mondstadt as a child.
Tell me you didn't pay attention to the game. Dad of all people. True, because Kaya said it.
All right, that last question was a little bit.
Yes, dude, welcome back. How are you?
About keeping you on your toes.
It only makes sense they'd save the best for last.
Okay, Queen.
I've got a very special question in mind. Hope you brushed up on your history, folks. True or false? One of Liyue's protectors killed a monster with nothing but her waistline.
Yeah, I know this one. This is true. This is true. Waistline is definitely a way to put it.
During the Archon War, a monster tried to swallow Ganyu, only for her waist to catch in its throat. The poor beast ended up choking to death. A fact that embarrasses Ganyu to this day.
Poor
honestly,
thing.
I think Ganyu is perfect just the way she is. Aww. And it saved her life. You know, when you think about it, we're really lucky that monster didn't succeed. Because Ganyu is a pretty great friend. And we're lucky to have her on the
she
team.
She is a pretty great friend.
The last round for this year.
Oh my god. Far, I think I did pretty good. I think I got like most of them right.
If you got three questions or less, don't sweat it. This was
no, I definitely got more than three, right?
Besides, this just
was anyone keeping score?
To discover. If you got 4 to 7 questions, then you're pretty well traveled. Just remember, there's lots to
can
see
I get
when you go off
Primos or?
If you got more, then you're a real lore expert. I'm sure you've got plenty of theories about where the story's headed. Maybe some headcanons too. But don't rest
our
on
friendship
your laurels
hanged on
just
on you. You did better than most streamers.
Waiting just beyond the horizon.
Maybe
thank
I need
so
to
playing,
enter those trivia competitions.
Now, whether you are an OG or you're brand new to the game, I just want to say
I'm somewhere in the middle.
Thank you for being here. We couldn't do this without you. It is so much fun to experience this game through your eyes, and I cannot wait
actually,
to see
I'm
where
brand
we go
new
next.
To the game. I've actually never played it before. It's gonna be my first time today. A jaw! Hello! Look at him, he's so silly. I need an Ajaw plushie, even though he's not plushie material. I need a plushie. Ajaw Flappy Bird? Flappy Ajaw. Yeah, I'm starting at 5.0. Yeah, I'm not even gonna be able to get to play any of this content because I have to do all the other quests first. I'm starting a new account for an Emily only run. Real. This segment goes on for way too long. It's okay. If this... I want this to be like an actual game, like in-game. 10 minutes? Oh my god, you guys went wrong. Holy. Get it, Ajaw. Get it. 1450? Okay, this is good enough, good enough, good enough. Cooking! Him go. They obviously worked very hard on this. Flappy Bird Ajaw game. That's what I'm saying. Like, just like once a week. Once a week. 10 primos. I don't care. Gedjud 2048. Oh my gosh. I love 2048. Okay, is this trailer? Okay, here we go.
We've arrived at the final phase.
Oh.
The winner of this match will take the final spot among the victors. Give it up for a long time contender and first time finalist.
Oh, his eyes are good.
From this point forward, everything we know about the real world no longer applies.
Oh.
Anything can happen here. There's something in the depths of this place that feels
whoa.
Familiar, yet also foreign.
The pilgrimage is not merely a
abyss energy.
Determine the strongest among us.
The pilgrimage.
Upon which to showcase your individual growth.
Eee, that's my boy!
The purpose of the pilgrimage is not only to select strong warriors, but also to collect contending fire from the battles.
Oh my god, she's so
that
cute.
Is only safe from the invasion of the abyss, while the sacred flame burns eternal.
The sacred flame. Oh, I love their special effects, man. Oh, I haven't seen that enemy before.
Guess I'll have to wait until the next pilgrimage.
Oh. Are you not old enough?
I'm still not sure why Arwayup chose me of all people.
It took the combined efforts of the then Pyro Archon and heroes from every tribe to finally repel the Abyss. Even so, the effects
The dinosaurs!
Only able to be reversed little by little.
Our current Archon achieved an overwhelming victory. The result was obvious from the beginning. I really want to win this time and become a true warrior!
But through our long history of fighting the Abyss, we realized things aren't quite so simple.
Oh man, the Night Kingdom. It's so colorful.
It has the capacity to read the memories of this land at any given moment.
Going there, the Night Kingdom?
Only those who triumph over the Abyss earn the right to be revived. Defeat not only means death, but also the destruction of your ancient name, preventing it from ever being inherited again.
You
your ancient
heard
name.
Something from here, didn't you?
Kinich, what is the meaning of this?
Only one way to awaken Kinich. You all from your willful blindness. More sacrifices must be made.
You'll die if you try to make your way forward. Why don't you just give up?
You want to know why I won't give up?
Whoa. Oh, that little thing is so cool.
Your next sacrifice.
Natlan is on the verge of destruction. It's very possible our nation has less than a year before total devastation.
Once your ancient name disappears, there's no
domain. Jessica!
Why can't I find him? Why?
Every great display of power comes at a price.
The tragedy of your short life.
Oh, Yantan looks so good.
Nothing of all encompassing power.
We shall unite the tribes and save Natlan from its impending doom.
Yeah, Gero.
What
oh my god.
Gnosis in your hands.
Capitano?
I don't know what you mean. But it sounds like this is about more than the Tsaritsa.
Sunglasses!
And now it falls to me to create new rules for now.
Ooh!
People like us. Let our blades do the talking!
Oh, the hair! Oh my god! Dude, Capitano looks so good. He looks so good. Oh my gosh, hi, Dawei. Oh, I have chills. Chills. Oh my goodness. My goodness. Hi, Balanced. Welcome back, how are you? Yeah, it looks like Cryo Sword on a Capitano. She looks Claymore. That looks like a Claymore to me. Also, hi, Cookie. On site. Whoa. Cool. Oh, those must be all the little tribes. Hello, Dawei.
我是你们老朋友大伟哥，那么今天呢，我们来到我们的项目组老朋友啊，战斗设计师鸡哥，我们的IP负责人小罗浩。Hello，大家好，我是大家的老朋友鸡哥。嗨。欢迎来到我们点零的前瞻节目呢，也是要跟大家去分享一下我们在新的版本，也就是纳塔这片区域上的游戏内容的一些设计思路和设计理念。大家好，我是你们的小朋友小罗浩。
The music, oh, they all have shirts of the little creatures.
大版本啊，就是和大家分享一些我们纳塔的视野观和角色相关的一些信息和情报。哎，欢迎我们的小朋友老罗浩和鸡哥来到我们的前瞻节目。Welcome，thank you。那么我们今天啊的这个前瞻节目跟以往有点不一样啊，可能要给大家一些小小的挑战。啊啊，挑战？
我们的挑战吗？
Me when they said there'd be trivia. Me when they.
那大家别紧张啊！哎，之前我们不是做过一轮那个？
Dev's just like us for real. Do I get primos?
感兴趣的。
那么今天啊，我们也是专门把这些问题挑出来，请你们两位现场来给大家那个解答
啊。现场答吗？
就没
有。It's a little quiet. Let me turn it up a tad.
肯定是大家都很熟悉的问题啊。那么要不先试试看？
试试就试试呗。
Is that better?
好，那我们开始第一轮挑战啊。那我看一下，我们第一个问题啊，好像是比较特殊的。
特殊的。
问题还有特殊问题吗？
让我们来看 VCR。
在 4.0 版本的前瞻直播当中，项目组有提到过每年都会推出一个新的玩法，那这次就是新的大世界移动体系。那选择它作为原神纳塔版本新
玩法的原因是什么？
在制作的过程当中有解决什么技术上的难题吗？
我觉得这个人这么熟悉一点，因为刚好我也是战斗设计师。
哇 bro
专业领域嘛。我先说一个比较大的概念啊，就是原神它其实是一个开放世界游戏。
Hi here, welcome back.
大家都知道对吧？但在
bottom right message in the bottom right corner
开放设计游戏它更大的条一个是关于玩家交互行为
Yes. Has it ever been on a live stream before? I know I've seen that before on other things, usually trailers, but the whole live stream, I don't know. I don't know about that.
It's
typically on like, yeah, like trailers.
对，
那这次我们想换一个思路，我们想在交互的形式上去做一些花样，尤其是其实玩家其实更关注我们的角色。
At the end of like patch notes and stuff.
对，因为原本
they usually put that there.
在比如说1.6 的版本，我们有一个新增的
Wave Rider
叫浪船
啊，对
吧？然后在3.6版本，我们做了一个叫花灵的这样的一个族群。那么他们
Yeah, the work in progress message is usually there for like the like gameplay stuff.But not this.
我们其实想做一个尝试，就是，把这些东西，全都呈现在角色自己的行为模式里。对，那其实大家在4.8和4.7这两个版本前瞻的彩蛋里面也看到了一些端倪，就是包括我们展出的这三位角色，他们都会有各自不同的行为方式。
啊，我理解了，就是说我们。这角色的这个移动能力是不是要得到空前的这个
unprecedented changes？
你看，就是之前我也看到过有旅行者在社区里面有说到，那这次我们是不是可以有一些飞檐走壁的
my God, parkour
这样的一些行为模式嘛？那大家也都在视频当中也有看到，我们确实是在做这样的尝试。
哎，我看到还有玩家问到说那个前瞻彩蛋里面那个马纳尼踩的那个滑板，它到底是个道具啊，还是
人？
其实我觉得就是要说的话，它其实是算技能，但是我觉得呢，就像刚才我说的一样，其实这些新角色的行为模式是融入到它的方方面面的，就它作为一个技能来说，可能有点狭隘吧。然后第二条其实是如果把它作为道具的话呢，感觉有点。
他应该是伙伴才对。
对，应该是伙伴。
这个我感觉我
said it's a friend, not an object.
这个第一个问题，我感觉这个还可以。
So it is like Molani specific, but is reflective of abilities that we can pick up in the real world, is what I'm understanding.
又是一个彩蛋调动。让我们来看第二段 VCR。
はい、皆さんこんにちは、マグロヘッド
です。Oh, that's a sick shirt.
今回は全身チームにバージョン 5.0 に関する質問をしてみたいと思います。ナタ初報 PV で数種類のドラゴンが
I don't know what the pattern is of the selection of characters on the shirt and why those four, but it's cool.
飛んでいくドラゴンいましたけど、あんな感じで飛行してみたいです。それとナタのキャラクターって独自の探索システムとかは持っているんでしょうか？よければたっぷり教えてください。
也是一位我们的老朋友。
这一位其实我也看过，好像是叫
金枪鱼头。
对，金枪鱼头，对对对对。
卡亚系列攻略我很喜欢。
对，包括七人召唤他也特别喜欢。
啊，对对对，是。
OK，
那 he must be like a creator or something。
龙的探索机是设计的。
对
啊，他提到说在我们 PV 的末尾是有一个飞行的龙。
Yeah, the bird thing。
因为可能
透，
今天是干货，干货。
那其实就是包括这条飞行的龙在内啊，纳塔所有的玩家看到的这种不同形态的龙，他们各自都会有一套独特的探索机制。那这个探索机制呢，和刚才这个问题里面我们提及的，包括纳塔的角色 他们之间也会有一些息息相关的设计点。
So will everyone have their own exploration or just the first three?
好像可以操作这些龙进行探索，那到底是我们通过某种方式驯化了这条龙，还是说我们把自己放到这个龙的体内怎么怎么样，对吧？那其实我想说的是，我们其实提供了一种类似附身的这样的一个机制。
附身，
对，可以让旅行者在纳塔的领域区域内，去通过附身的这样一个机制去获得这些龙的操作权。那不同
，So we possess them. Is what you're saying?
一些本领。
对对对，我感觉基哥的意思说到我们到纳塔之后啊，我们是可以真飞檐走壁，对吧？
对，没错没错。那还是回归到刚才金枪鱼头提到的那个问题啊，就是我们会不会有飞行的可能？
flying.
大家可以敬请期待。
we're not gonna tell you.
提供的内容。
I really like the collection of blankets slash rugs on the table. They're very pretty.
有超过三成的玩家提到我们整个纳塔的这个世界观，就是大家都想了解，比如说纳塔的这个设计这个灵感是从哪里来啊？
Where did the design inspiration for Natland come from?
包括觉得纳塔也是一个这种人龙共生的这么一个国家，所以想请小龙号跟我们讲讲。
Yes, please share.
我们这个人和龙之间到底是一个什么样的这个
？Chaska's kind of been growing on me, dude. I love Chaska.
部族当中啊，龙啊被纳塔人视为自己的家族成员。
对
，I love Chaska.
可能不很差的比喻，有点像我们养猫猫狗狗一样。
Oh, that's so cute. Stop.
对，那我还是愿意养农的。
有机会，但我也很想。他们在一起生活，在一起工作、战斗，彼此信任呢，也彼此照顾。虽然纳塔的人和龙伙伴之间可能没有办法直接用语言相通，但是长久的相处呢，也能够让他们能够弄懂彼此的心思和一些就是习惯了。
对。
那么我们旅行者在拜访各个不同部族的时候呢，就可以发现纳塔人和龙伙伴相处的方式可能也会有些不一样。就比如说在我们应该第一个接触的部落回声之子中，稳重可靠的疾风龙伙伴呢，会帮助他们的部族成员挖掘宝石和矿物，或者呢在山洞当中去开辟。
The little chunky boys。
对，然后呢，同时呢，他们的爪子和那个钻角呢，就很需要就是人类伙伴的照顾了。那这个地方我也就简单的先抛一抛，因为我们5.0会接触到这三个部族的龙伙伴，然后在之后的环节当中，我们会有专门的同学来给大家进行更详细的演绎。
对，
这里我就先小卖一个关子。
对，就接下来的环节，我们还会有更多相关信息的爆料给大家提供。
对对对对对，我听
完小王介绍，感觉
纳塔啊，人和龙是一种非常和谐共生啊，而且是非常有爱的这样一种氛围啊，我觉得非常期待啊。那么我们接下来看这个第三题，那第三题呢也是个特殊问题，我们来看 VCR。
我们看这次又是哪位大佬。
So guys,
Wait,
I'm Twanto.
Hi, Jake.
Some questions for the Genshin team regarding 5.0.
Hello.
Pyro's the spotlighted element for the new update, specifically for Natlan. And I'm curious, how does Pyro have a significance in Natlan? Will Natlan be more accessible for
Very good question,
Mr. Because I do know that a lot of new players have difficulties and or struggle to get to the newer pieces of content that get added to the game. Honestly, it is insane that we are at Natlan now. I want to give you guys all my luck, because if I can't win the 50-50, I hope at the very least you can.
Oh, thank you.
And I hope you find your own true meaning on your own journey in Genshin Impact.
这一位我也认识。
Woo, Jake.
提问。
Oh, that's great that he got to be in it. Good for him.
火之国说一说，就是火之国。那火在纳塔呢，有着独一无二的。
Good questions, too. What is bro doing here?
除了纳塔还存在着广泛存在着一种名为燃素的物质。那燃素呢，有着不同的形态，每一种都有很独特的作用。这一点呢，我觉得旅行者一进纳塔探索就能自己亲身体验到了。
那在纳塔，其实大家可以把燃素认知为一种
Phlogiston
独有的高阶的
能源
火元素的呈现形式。
啊，
它有时候
advanced form of the pyro，
有的时候又可能作为一种战斗当中的策略资
源。Like、
当然除了战斗方面的价值和探索方面价值以外呢，它本身也有很重要的精神层面的一些意义。
火就是纳塔的精神图腾嘛。
对，
就像我们纳塔的最核心的建筑物地标圣火竞技场，
没错，
里面有昂扬不灭的圣火，火就象征着纳塔人他们永不屈服的一种精神。然后纳塔历代
有很多英雄的英杰，他们
用自己的精神和力量将纳塔
火。It's very hot.
不断地向未来、向新一代去传递。无论他们遇见了怎样的艰难和挑战，他们的火都不会熄灭。
我们一直知道那个纳塔被称为是这个战争的这个国度啊，那么其中这个战争的含义是什么呢？
之所以说纳塔是战争的国度，是因为纳塔在历史上曾经面临过无数场危机。那么为了保护自己的家园，我们之前提到纳塔的人民还有纳塔的龙，他们一起并力同心抵御着各种侵害纳塔的势力。那么在一场又一场这样的战斗中涌现出了无数的英雄，那他们在这种战斗和战争中留下的英勇事迹呢，就被记录下来，在黑曜石上刻写成为古名。
哦， Obsidian， oh that's so cool。
核心的
Obsidian Honkai Star Rail，
将英雄们的事迹和精神传承下去。那么一代又一代的纳塔人呢，在古民的引导下不断的成长，不断的去战斗，和过去那些他们历史上的英雄们一样，用自己的力量支撑着纳塔在一个巨大的威胁之下屹立不倒。那么到了如今呢，六大部族之间依然会彼此竞争，在圣火竞技场所举办的大赛中比拼各项的能力，从而选拔出最为强大的战士，继续向着战场去进发。
对，所以也就是说纳塔的这个战争并不是我们理解的那个战争，是
okay. So it's not quite what we speculated it might be, but
既包含了竞技，也包含了可能大家广泛认知的战斗。但是呢，通过竞技选拔出来的英雄们，他们要和什么样的势力去进行对抗？他们又如何
看待就
是他们身处的战争？那就请玩家朋友们
，Dude, Yansan looks good。
即将开始的主线剧情中去切身体验了。
几乎有这个五成的这个问卷啊。
Substance proposed by 18th century chemists to exist in all combustible bodies and be released in combustion. So, explosions is what I'm hearing.
火神嘛，我们简单来说，他就是纳塔人的领袖，就是纳塔所有战士里面的最强人、最强者。那火神率领着纳塔战士们迎接了无数的战争，也夺得了无数场胜利。无论面对怎样的敌人，火神的火焰从来没有暗淡过半分。就是对于纳塔人来说啊，还有纳塔的龙。只要跟随着火神，他们就可以战胜任何胆敢侵犯纳塔的敌人。他就像是一轮永不落下的太阳，在他的照耀之下，所有的迷茫和不安都会被驱除。那么当我们的旅行者啊，到我们的纳塔和火神马维卡相遇的时候，再和他一起踏入战场，想必也会一定会体会到马维卡的热情，感受到他的光芒和温度。那至于他的性格，我觉得大家很快就能够体会到他所拥有的那种和他的力量相匹配的那种王者一样的那种自信啊。
对对，我印象特别深刻，因为我看我们纳塔前传短片的时候啊，看到当火神马尔卡走出来之后充满了这个自信啊。
对对对，
前面聊了这么多。
I love when they say, oh, when I watched this, it was so cool, like they were watching it for the first time ever.
안녕하세요쌤입니다오늘은원신팀에게 5.0 버전과관련된몇가지질문을드릴건데요우선나타는발자취형상을보면부활과관련된뭔가있는것으로보이는데혹시원신세간에이미죽은누군가가부활한
다는 asking the real question.
중요한 캡틴 두꺼운톡으로쓰고있는데설마나타의무더운날씨에기절해버리는건아닐까싶습니다
这两个特别有意思的
I'm sorry, who's fainting from heat stroke?
那这也是剧情上的问题吧我来说一说就是
Stop asking us questions about the story.
我可能说的远一些，就是战争的国度嘛，它必然会伴随着牺牲，那死亡从来都无法被轻易逆转。
Oh, scary music.
但是在纳塔，唯独在纳塔，就是我们英雄们的火焰不太会轻易的熄灭。就我们足迹皮语里面说到，戴英说过一句谜语嘛，就败者成为战火的余烬而胜者重燃。
对，
那在纳塔，牺牲是无法阻拦英雄们奋战的脚步的，他们是有机会去继续战斗，直到那一场战争彻底的终结。那至于是怎样的一个重燃的这个机制，不要卖一个关子，因为这个就是我们可能纳塔的剧情里面一个
revival of previous Archon revival of
最难受的那一个。
那你是队长吧？
行行 ，OK， 就是那队
长。Some people may hope Senora
纳塔的整个主线剧情当中也扮演了一个非常重要的角色。对，那刚才小罗浩所说到的重燃，包括战争这些概念，某种意义上也是队长来到这片土地的原因。对对，那刚才至于刚才那个比较
不能说太多了
stop。
至于说刚才那个奇妙的问题说他会不会在纳塔中暑，那我可能再 剧透一下，就是可能某由于某种原因，我觉得他不太可能会中暑。
哦，我感觉我已经 get 到一些信息了啊。那个，既然两位都说到了这个火神与队长啊，那么我们娜塔的其他新角色
，He said for some reason Capitano won't get heatstroke. Is he a cryo?
不过在此前啊，我们先看一段短片。
Cryo Herald or something? Sus. Okay, Queen. Oh my god, it's Paimon. He did use Cryo in the trailer, yeah. We did not see a vision, correct? However, Kama probably has a delusion.
Yay, Walani.
Same. Oh. Oh, I wish my room looked like that. Dang. Cat. Do not hurt the cat. Okay. Car. Maybe he's Chi Chi's dad. Get it, girl. She looks so unamused sitting in her little thingy. Knitch. A dilemma. Dude, what the heck? You had it. You had it. Woo! Kenich! Look at him, he's so cool. Look at him fly. Whee. Oh, it's my little Minecraft man. Yee. First code. I think these might be expired. Perhaps. Naruto and Sasuke real. Real. Oh, this art is cool. I didn't look at it fully in the video, but oh, her outfit is so pretty. What? Why is Chaska so tiny? Also, where is Olurun? I mean Olurun. They expire at midnight tonight? Okay. Get your codes if you haven't yet. Yeah, and Shilonen and Silali. What are they? Maybe not involved yet, I guess.
女性们，欢迎回来。那到这里呢，节目组交给我的任务呢，已经圆满完成了。
Thank you, Oracle.
就结束了吗？
接下来啊，我们就把现场交给项目
Project Team Members.
两位啊，为大家介绍五点零版本的。
She's so lovely. She is cute.
我呢，就提前下班了。
这样的吗？那
好，介绍。
这什么情况？
那我俩来呗。
那我换个姿势啊，我换个姿势。
那既然聊到旅行
，Backstage observing，
还是鸡哥，你作为战斗设计师，你先来。
OK， 好。那刚才
Combat Designer
的时候也说到呢，在纳塔的六个部族当中，他们有一些身怀绝技的各个部族的勇士。那么这三位角色也是来自于不同的三个部族的勇士。
哎，那么在纳塔的魔神任务第一幕《荣花与炎日之途》中
，OK， two acts
就可以和这三位勇士一同
Black Stone Under a White Stone
举行的。归火盛宴巡礼，见证这场对纳塔最高荣誉的角逐。不过啊，说到勇士这个称呼啊，在这三位勇士当中，可能有一位小姑娘。
There might be a young girl。
啊，这么认可自己。
OK， 我知道你在说哪一位了，那就是在之前的
Gacino。I'm obsessed with her mittens。
一位小姑娘叫。
I'm obsessed。
卡奇娜是
霍顿大学
回声之子的古名持有者，而她的古名。乌沙伯蒂、
哎、
意思是坚强
坚强，
虽然他自己并不明白为什么会被赐予这个伟大的名字，因为有很多古代的英杰和先烈他们都持有这个名字，但是他认为他既然得到了这个殊荣，他就有义务参与这个在圣火竞技场举行的归火盛宴巡礼。虽然他一直 屡战屡败，但是他也屡败屡战，所以他真的很坚强。
在我们看来，就是这样一位小姑娘，她每次都能坚持参加，那我觉得应该也是一个很了不起的人。她的
She's very determined.
我们把她叫做冲天转转，也是大
家 Turbo Twirly
像钻头一样的载具，我觉得也一定能帮她在比赛中提供一定的助力吧。那首先卡西亚就像大家看到的那样，她其实是一位岩元素神之眼的持有者，那么她也会通过自己的技能来召唤出刚才我们一直有聊到的那个
冲天转转，
冲天转转就是这样一个像钻头一样的载具。那么它也有不同的方式跟冲天转转之间进行交互，比如说它可以
直接
骑乘到冲天转转上，然后通过这种方式来提供快速移动呀、攀爬墙面呀，以及可以在这种情况下去冲击地面来攻击敌人。那它同样也可以把冲天转转当做一个单独的战斗单位进行召唤，那么它也会独立的产生岩元素伤害，而它的元素爆发会划定一个施工场地一样的领域。那在这个领域里面
，Oh my God, the warning signs！
冲天转转也会获得一些强化的能力。
Cute。
除了这些战斗的技巧以外，那卡奇娜当然她作为部族的勇士也有一些当地人的从容。那么她熟悉大塔的当地区域，也就是说，她可以在玩家探索过程中，在旅行者的小地图上显示纳塔区域特展的位置。
Saurian Claw, oh succulent！
没错，而且他在去和纳塔的一部分采集物交互的时候呢，还会去恢复全队的体力。
这也算是四星角色里面他。
I wanna put those in my teapot, but just to look at.
一个好帮手了。
旅行者们呢，在纳塔的魔神任务，也就是融化。
Oh, she's free.
这样一个魔神任务当中。
Oh, dang.
不久就会遇到卡奇娜。
Also, Hydro Traveler.
然后他就会很自然的加入到主角的冒险队伍当中了。那我们说了这么多关于卡奇娜的传闻啊，那接下来我们要介绍的
马拉尼
这位同伴就是来自流泉之众部落的马拉尼。
用卡奇娜她自己的话来说
，If I was not pulling for her, Kinich, I would pull for her. She's pretty cute.
那作为流泉之众的成员呢，马拉尼她酷爱各类水上运动，比如说游泳、跳水、冲浪，还有沙滩排球。但比起自己玩的开心，她更享受和大家一起度过美妙的时光。无论是她作为水上用品商店的店主呢
，Does she have the chibi animations? I wonder, like the running animations and stuff. We really only saw her walk.
充满乐趣和惊喜的旅程。那么在部族祭文流泉之众当中呢，旅行者就有
Natland Amber
踏上一场探寻传说中啊神秘岛屿的一个旅程。那相信已经横跨五国的旅行者一定不会错过这样的冒险和挑战，
因为他也是流泉之众的勇士。那么他在战斗当中也
会 First four star in every nation history. Oh, you're so right. I forgot about that.
可以看到马拉尼是一位使用水元素的法系
Catalyst
对，他是一位法系角色，那会搭乘一个叫沙沙冲浪板的这样的一个水上用品来提升自己在地面和水面上的这样一个行动能力。那马拉尼
本身是一个
攻击节奏可能不那么快的角色
faster than Furina，
利用自己的身法为自己接下来发动的这次攻击去积攒一些优势。所以他在移动
limited use， I wonder if there's 100% uptime on it，
可能本身并没有
probably not but I'm
很强的效果，但是在之后马拉尼主动发起的攻击当中，这些行为会给他提供非常大的注意
啊，就积累资源，
对，没错，
从而得到更大的优势。
对，那他的元素爆发呢，也会发射一个巨大的
沙沙弹
，Oh
my God, her burst is so cute！
有很多涂鸦性质的这样的一些表现，对吧？让别人能够充分感受到来自流泉之众的这样一种。水上运动的精神。然后刚才说到了马拉尼的一些作战能力啊，那其实除了在战斗当中在敌人之间进行穿梭以外呢，
这
个沙沙冲浪板的这个状态，它还可以帮助马拉尼在一些特殊的地方自由的穿梭，而且它还拥有一套
What was that thing? Is that like a
的探索的能力
？So what does the map look weird?
它也可以在小地图当中去显示纳塔区域特展的位置。
哇，那不愧是我们流泉之众最好的向导呀！它的移动方式又很特别，然后又很灵活，而且还能帮助我们去探索大世界。
除此之外，它还有一些别的能力，也就是说，它在纳塔这些存在燃素。刚才我们有
没有说到
这个概念？就在燃素。
Where's my hydroclaymore？
和一部分的采集物进行交互呢？它还可以去恢复整个队伍的燃素值。
In the abyss, I guess. I don't know.
最后一位。则是来自我们玄牧人部族。
Yeah, I do believe she is. She is supposed to have Hawaiian inspiration.
看起来算有些沉默寡言。
Hi, buddy. Oh, look, you have a little computer. It's so cool.
兽和恶龙的方法，
同时他也是少数能在归火盛宴巡礼中多次
胜的人。 Oh my gosh, he's a winner.
跟金尼奇这样的人一样啊，就玄牧人这个部落里有不少的部落成员都喜欢挑战极限。
Scions of the Canopy.
对，然后他们的实力肯定也不同凡响。
Extreme sports.
有什么独家秘诀？比如说我注意到金尼奇好像不是孤军作战，对，他身边其实有一个很奇怪的
John, what are you doing?
伙伴，对，那这个伙伴
是为他的战斗
提供不小的助力。那他有没有什么来头呢？
那这位自称伟大圣龙的酷酷的阿乔，我们大家都称呼他阿乔吧，和金尼奇是几乎形影不离的。
阿乔，我感觉他的画风跟其他人不太一样啊。那你说长相
？Haley, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome in.
性格感觉也很奇怪。我感觉他在之前的影片里面体现出来的那个感觉挺狂妄自大的。
确实，就是阿乔和金尼奇可以说是完全不一样的性格。
My God.
阿乔的性格特别恶劣，而且大部分时间他都在和金尼奇斗
嘴。I'm so ready for this dynamic.
伙伴确实也会为金尼奇他自己招致的一些非议，但好像来说就是金尼奇也不是很在意，就是他并不屑于靠语言来为自己辩白，他总是一个怎么说呢，意志很坚定，目标很清晰，他就是完成自己的委托，然后去向委托人去收取他任何合适的报酬。而更多关于金尼奇还有玄牧人的作品，以及他继承了古民的秘文呢，旅行者们都可以通过我们的部族祭文玄牧人的任务，然后得到进一步的解答。
那同样也轮到我来介绍一下金尼奇的战斗技能了。
OK, yes.
大家也看到了，他是一个擅长
extreme sports
运动的这样的一个少年，所以在战斗当中，他也会用类似的技能，通过元素战技进行快速的移动。除此以外，他的元素战技在连接到敌人之后呢，还会发动一些特殊的。
Nanar Soul, thank you for the follow. Welcome in.
他会发射一种很厉害的像手炮一样的。
Dude, that looks like so much. Look at the ways.
回力凝炮，感觉是个很中二的名字。对，他瞄准了敌人发出强力的一击，而他释放元素爆发的时候呢，在他身边
啊 ，so cool，
然后就会解放自己的力量。
Oh my god，
摧毁眼前的敌人
啊。Looks like he's made out of Legos。
其他两位勇士一样，你大概会猜到基尼奇在纳塔的大地上也会。
I read something else. Win，
这也太好了吧！就是我们五点零的这三位伙伴都能够帮助我们去。收集纳塔的特产，
没错，因为基尼奇他也有限。
Regional specialty character, amazing, and I'm pulling for him.
全部人部族成员的能力，也就是他和
部族成员交互的时
候，还可以去提升队伍中所有角色的移动速度。
我已经就预见到。
And movement speed, let's go.
助力了，这三位角色身上会有特殊的。
Babacar, hello, welcome back, and Healy, welcome to chat.
有些纳塔的风格，就像周身有火焰在燃烧一样的感觉。
Yeah, the glow.
Oh,
it's so cool.
是一种新机制，然后我们把这种机制和纳塔本土的一些世界观结
合起来。And their tattoos kind of move too. Night Soul's blessing.
叫夜魂加持的状态，在战斗中充分发挥它的作用。
这种能力，我就接过话茬，是通过我们被称为一种叫做燃素刻录的仪式来激发的，借助一种古老的仪式啊，在纳塔地区神之眼的持有者。不仅可以与部族的大灵和地脉进行沟通，还能
通过仪式
强化自己的实力。
OK， 这个大灵听起来好像是什么部族的
？Oh right, the biblically accurate angels.
图腾和信仰这样的。
哦，原来如此。那也就是说，
都是 so cool 的。
这种全新概念的加入，会导致纳塔会有一些完全不一样的体验。
对。
那我们作为设计者呢，其实也对这些体验做了一些便利性的设计。那我们从 5.0 开始，重新制作了一部分且是伸手的活动场地。
Created part of the environment of test run.
场地会变成一个完全是纳塔风格的。
Oh, it's open world.
旅行者们就可以在这样的一个区域里面很方便的去测试角色的各项能力，进行更深度的游玩和体验。我知道肯定介绍完这三个角色之后，那大家也会再问。
Wait, that's kind of cool.
旅行者在每个国家，只要他触碰一下七天神像，就可以获得这个国家的相关元素的对这个能力。那么在纳塔，他是不是也能够
Pyro Traveler
接触到火元素的能力，并且也和这些角色一样，有夜魂加持的效果呢？
哎，提到这个就要提前和大家声明一下了。那么这次旅行者来到纳塔和七天神像进行初次共鸣的时候呢，由于某种不知名的原因，旅行者并不能立刻
化作处理。
那关于这个奇怪
的现象，已经
涉及到了我们现在纳塔面临到的一些种种的危机。那等旅行者们在纳塔的旅程进一步深入，
What do you mean I can't have Pyro Traveler right away？
我相信啊， 除了刚才介绍的到这些新朋友
It better be broken
还有一些娜娜的角色因为之前我们有过以凡聊著名的这样的一个视频
对
比如说啊我们还有更早期的一个卫星角色就是
足迹当中的
对对对就是足迹 PV 里
面的
易安山包括像我有印象的还有
Jessica
对吧还有火神这样的角色那么他们在剧情当中是否都会在 5.0 的版本中登场呢
哎七哥就观察的很仔细 I love
Jessica
那么我们先说恰斯卡吧他是一个
I also love Kachina's tattoos
个性洒脱
getting ready for Natland dude it's so soon
非常文明的调停人这么一个身份
oh she's a mediator wait what did they say
任务当中呢他也和我们一起参与到某项
Sorry. I need to know about Jessica.
先说，恰斯卡吧，他是一位来自
Flower Feather Clan, free spirit and personality, impressive strength, meteor among various tribes.
Third
Sherpa, thank you so much for the 3 months. Also, welcome back. How are you?
刚才提到的来自于沃鹿之邦的我们的健身教练
Yanson's a fitness instructor. Shut up. That's so cute. Oh my god, she looks so good. I might pull. Not gonna lie. However, you to watch your reaction to Arlecchino short and really liked it. Thank you. Oh, of course. Thank you so much. I'm glad you enjoyed it and welcome to Twitch. Hello.
对，也请期待就我们的队长和火神。
Oh, run!
强者对强者之间，他们会擦出这样的火花吧？而在其他引燃 PV 中出现的角色，就比如说来自我们魂神之子的希诺
米， oh, hello, beautiful.
来自夜迷主的希特拉米和欧洛伦等等，他也会在后续的版本中陆续与各位旅行者们见面。那么在介绍完角色之后呢，就接下来拜托我们鸡哥揭晓一下角色活动起源的具体安排吧。
终于到了大家问。
Well, they show every character except Oron. Yeah, we really only get that blurry clip of him. That's it.
那么在五点零版本的第一阶段，也就是上半段
，OK，All right，OK，Kachina's on there， but that's fine. If we get a free one, that's fine. That's fine. That's fine. Oh my god, I have more time to save.
而在卡池的下半期呢
，Let's go.
将会迎来基尼奇和雷电将军。
Right and re. OK.
旅行者们可千万不要错过。
All right.
此外呢，全新五星双。
No more engulfing lightning for me, I guess.
冲浪时光也将出现在武器活动起源中。同时，纳塔地区也新增了五把可锻造武器。
哇 ！Yay, craftables！
寻找阿龙。
Oh, they're pretty. I really like the sword.
前瞻的一系列的活动当中，我们会推出一个名为“出发火之国”的 H5 网页活动。那参与这个网页活动呢，旅行者不但能够直观地了解到即将上线的 5.0 版本的新内容，
What is this?
还能在版本更新后直接通过这个 H5 的玩法获取三。
Oh, it's just a web event, and you get some of them for free.
所有关于这些活动的具体内容呢，也请关注官方后续的公告，了解更多的活动详情。那除了刚才说的全新的武器以外呢？
I thought you'd love that weapon banner. Yeah, I just may not have enough. Ooh, I may not have enough wishes to do both of those things. I love that top set. That is beautiful. Obsidian Codex. Oh, that's gorgeous.
来获取这两套圣遗物。那我一口气讲了这么多，应该没有漏掉什么吧？
It didn't say. It didn't say anything about the sets. No. Okay. Sorry. Yeah, the black one is sick. The other one is pretty too. I love the black one. With the blue. It's kind of like same colors as the Bond of Life set, but it's glowy and pretty.
到此为止，告一段落了。
嗯，没错。
那么我也圆满完成了今天的任务。
啊，
那我也要。
Goodbye, Aquaria.
So, 所以说大伟哥今天台上就只剩我一个人了吗？
你可以自己想办法呀。
啊，我自己想办法。好，那我就先不说了。
Accepted reality.
我的小伙伴们，
然后。He said, "Dawei, do I have to be up here alone?"
那请大家拭目以待。
Did you pull for Emily? I did not know. She's cute. I like her, but I have to save for Knitch. He's my boy. Love him. Knitch, I think is what they said. Not that the way that they pronounce things are always correct, but you know.
I come from the Children of Echo.We're known for our mining skills. The Tepelosaurs are our friends.
Well, the paper animation is cool.
They help us find the prettiest ores and gems. And that means my tribe has all the best jewelers.
Music is good.
When we find a really special gemstone, we use it to decorate our weapons or jewelry. Oh, also, if you have time, you should come watch one of our dance-offs. They're super fun. Anyway, the other contestants we just saw are from
from the people of the spring.
Dude, this sounds like Kiwi. This is Kachino, right?
Alongside the Kaholosaurus. Our tribe is a really awesome.
This has got to be Mulani, but the first one was Kachino, right? She sounds like Kiwi.
Sorry. Got lost in the music for a sec. The people of my tribe love getting together to go.
Dang. Who are these NPCs? Hello? Hello?
My favorite thing is bathing in the hot springs. The Kaholosaurus like it too. That's why we're such good pals. But make sure you give him some space when it gets busy. And if a grumpy Kaholosaur bites
I'm sorry?
You, do not bite them back. A lot of places in Natland.
Alright, I'm gonna be hanging out there.
If you plan to go exploring, I recommend picking a guide from my tribe. For delivery,
wherever that is, that's where I'm gonna how to pull for an NPC.
Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of messengers. Everything from letters to packages.
Ooh, nice voice.
Being quick on our feet is one of our strengths. There's also our hunters who take on a wide range of commissions.
Dude, the music is so good.
Extreme sports are popular in my tribe. Don't worry, the Yunkasaurs will protect them.
Dude, who else does this guy voice?
Young people from my tribe come here.
I don't remember
his
name.
Challenge. Next up, there's.
Wait. Look, the competition's starting.
Next time then.
Who's gonna come out on top this time?
Change voice sounds like Don Hung. Yeah. Plus, like a tiny bit more emotion. Just a little bit. Second go, redeem your code. They haven't expired yet. They expire in like less than 2 hours. Ad break almost over. Is that who asked? Yeah, Kenichi. Yeah. Who, I forget who his voice actor is, but he sounds so familiar. That happens to me a lot with voice actors though. I'm like, they sound really familiar, but they just kind of like have a similar tone to someone else with a certain character. You're only gone well. Keep up the no spoilies. We can yap about it soon. I'm sure there's so much good stuff, and I'm so proud of you guys for holding it in. Got this. Oh? So, can I purchase one of those? Is my first question. I would like that. I would like, I don't know which one is my favorite. I think maybe the green one. Such a good nap. No, wait, I'm Yang.
平时的主要工作呢，主要是做龙。
然后今天呢，很高兴能到现场给大家亲自做一次龙。哎，大家好，我是原神的关卡设计师小八。很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下纳塔。很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下纳塔。那今天啊，我们请到。He's doing a great job。老杨来到现场呢，其实是我们接着刚才的话题，继续聊。我们已经知道了呀，就是纳塔是一个人和龙。 共生的国度，那刚才其实我们在之前的介绍里也有谈到说，哎，纳塔的地貌环境啊，其实也跟其他的国家非常的不一样。哎，
是的，我也其实也在网上看到了很多这样的评论。对于我们开发者来讲呢，纳塔也是一个非常具有特色的国度，潮酷和多彩是它的两个关键词。比方说，旅行者可以在巨大的山体上面看到多彩的涂鸦，或者是说在各个部落里面看到很多潮酷的药草。
Oh, it's so
colorful。这应该是我们纳塔会随时陪着我们在任务中的一个小伙伴，就是在纳塔我们已经知道它是一个人和龙结合的国度，所以我们整个的设计理念是围绕着人和龙怎么做的结合。没错，那上一趴我也有说到啊，就是旅行者可以通过
I can't with the little one on his shirt. It's so cute.
进行一些复杂的探索的行为。那接下来我就替老杨来介绍一下这位非常可爱的小伙伴吧。
I can't decide which of my favorites Orions between the green and the blue one.
就会遇到这一只特别的小疾风龙。
He's cute too.
我们当时称他为小家伙吧。小家伙呢，他会陪伴我们经历很多有趣的小故事，并且也会参与到重要的世界任务当中哦。
Oh, look at his little tummy.
那我知道就是刚才你也有谈到纳塔有非常多的部落的特色，那其实今天也很难得我们有三个小龙人在场。
One, two, three.
不如这次我们就眼见为实，
a tour.
玩家去逛一圈。
好呀，
可以啊，来来来，我们先去我们疾风龙的部落去看一下我的老家。
走走走，跟着他
走吧。
这里啊就是我们回声之子的部落。
Rocks.
大家可以看到，我们这个地方有很多的宝石，也有很多的矿石。同时呢，我们整个建筑的风格也看起来就跟岩元素很有关系。他已经是他们了，已经
带入了。
是的
，Men when presented with rocks， 哇哦！
我
觉
得
最强的战士，比如说像我这样的，才能够获得最好的宝石。
所以呢，我们去深耕了一下挖掘相关的一些技术。
我来为老杨补充一下，就是在回声之子周围呢，也有不少因为钻探和挖掘而被发现的奇特
景观。Abigail from Stardust, your top customer, you.
巨大的，含有大量固态。
Sorry, I'm an Abigail hater.
以及一些很神秘的可以一直向下挖掘的洞穴等等。
哎，你刚才其实小巴有提到啊，有很多值得去挖掘的区域。你刚才也说，对吧？你们部落是以宝石和挖掘做建长的，那你们的战斗伙伴，也就是疾风龙，想必也非常擅长这个领域的一些能力吧
？I love how they're just holding them.
地面上移动，看起来
This is my rock now.
但是借助燃素，它可以在地下快速的移动，还能翻山越岭，同时也能帮我们回声之子去探查地下。
So you share a name with her? I do, unfortunately.
他应该是你们这个部落的跑酷好手了。
哎，是的。
哎，你看，小巴那边还有一处，好像是你们部落的。
是的，这是我的老
家。The problem is that
接下来不如到我的老家去看一下吧。
She hangs around Sebastian too much, and he's mine, so it's unacceptable. She's also just annoying.
西游龙部族，流泉之众，就咱部落的人呢，是大多是热爱音乐，然后以及喜欢泡泡温泉休闲放松。
What?
然后包括他们的伙伴喜游龙，
日
常也是一副懒散甚至有那么一点迟钝的样子。虽然我们部族的人呢经常看起来是这么一副安逸的样子，但当遇到真正的战斗以及比赛的时候也都是
even in like their facial designs, like the facial structure, it doesn't look like NPCs that we've seen before.Like, it doesn't look like the same NPC model with different clothes on, you know? Liquid Phlogiston.
甚至有一点危险的这种地区。
哎，那既然它这么危险的话，是不是我在周边游玩的时候要特别小心才行？
其实也不用。
Oh, so we're jealous, yeah. Exactly. Your real name is Birim. That works. Yeah, I prefer Abby. Maybe that's another reason why I hate her, because I don't like going by Abigail. It's too grandma for me, personally.
Yunkasaurus. 就从龙本身开始说起吧。
可以啊，看一下跟我们疾风龙还有小巴他们骑游龙究竟有什么不同。
没问题。那孽龙呢，它最强大的能力当然就是自己觅食的能力了。大家就看见啊，在孽龙的夹带当中，其实储存了一种很特殊的叫做火硫果胶的物质。那每当孽龙要去觅食的时候呢，就会释放夹带当中的火硫果胶，用它粘住果实，然后送入口中。那在纳塔当然也会有一些富含燃素的果实，那孽龙呢也可以通过火灵果胶去吸收这些带有燃素的果实，并且在适当的时候去释放它们，造成爆炸
效果。Oh, so they just make bombs in their mouths? Okay, got it.
作为觅食的手段，在
Here gets cloak ancient devs get a cloak sensing a pattern. I want those cloaks also.
一个媒介。
那既然孽龙这么厉害，他们部族的人
Winter is coming and I need the cloak.
不得不说
River looks like Fonta, not lava. I want to drink it. You're so real for that. It does look good.
也会和他们的龙伙伴一样，在群山当中来回穿梭。所以呢，孽龙部族，也就是玄牧人部族的成员，他们多半呀，也都成为了冒险家。
My God, that's a man of a Fontaine.
快递人这样的一些职业。
The llamas.
旁边呢，其实有这么一个遍布高耸悬崖的遗迹——祖遗庙宇。和猎龙一起呢，旅行者
Dude, what's with the floating rocks in the ruins?
鸡哥呀，我还是非常在意刚才说的吃果子这个事儿。
What about Abiri? That's kind of cute, actually.
听过没有？
我感觉不是什么好八卦。
我听说有一只孽龙平时不是很自律，然后呢因为吃了太多的
骨头发
福，在洞穴下面再也回
来。 Oh no，
你可一定得保重啊。
啊，原来是这么一个。
Guys don't too eat too many fruits or else you'll get stuck in a cave。
知道了，所以老杨我们不如我们坐回去，就这件事情我跟你们再好好说道说道。好，哎，老杨，就接着刚才那个孽龙的话题啊，我觉得我必须要为他说句公道话。虽然这只孽龙它
，Oh my God，
它确实也困在一个地方出不来，但是呢，它实际上是孽龙当中非常古老的一只。
Stop！
那你就会问了，我们旅行者到底用什么方式来对付
？Oh my God，he's so pretty。Oh my God！
刚才说的有道理啊，就是它确实贪吃，所以旅行者们呢，在跟它对战的过程中，可以找到一些对付它的弱点，比如说它喜欢吃的东西。
Get him better。
对吧？
我觉得鸡哥更像是在
给自己辩解。It's giving danger chicken， but chunk
一定没有。哎，对啊，那我还不得不说一句啊，这个孽龙的 boss 长上去还是挺可爱的。
Stuck like on you， they did literally reference that earlier. I'm seeing patterns. Whoa， cool， gold flame。
有一只会飞的大龙。这个龙呢，其实也是我们5.0版本旅行者需要面对的一个敌人。
哎，但是我怎么记得那龙好像一般都是聚居的？为什么这只龙
？Why is Bennett here？
你也看出来，他跟我们现在
Bennett Lore Shirley，
这只巨大的家伙呢，是有一些特殊的原因的。这个地方我要先卖个关子。然后他不得已而为之，最后离开了自己的族群，生活在这片区域。啊，除了刚才我们介绍过的这个胖胖的孽龙和神秘的巨大飞龙呢？我们在纳塔的旅程中还有许多神奇的生物
，bird，
比如说看上去就很容易被撞的鸟，看上去就很憨的豚兽，看上去就很热的甲虫。
Ooh， I like that beetle。
会飞的老鼠。
I hope I don't need to collect them for a certain character, and they're not sporadically scattered throughout the map in really weird places that are not close together。
还有巨大的间歇喷发的火山，未来呢也会给旅行者们开放，
这个大家可以尽情期待。
大家都知道，我们在每个国家推出的时候都会有一套叫声望系统的系统内容
啊。
那这一次在 5.0 的版本，我们对这个声望系统做了一次全新的尝
试。Reputation system new。
这次呢，旅行者可以在各个部落的一个叫钥匙图腾柱的地方去接取对应部族的桃花。
Reputation in each tribe。
听上去不还是声望系统吗？
杰哥，你别骗我。
啊，对哦，好像说到这里，感觉它跟声望系统没有什么区别啊。但是呢，我还是说漏了一点。在之前的环节当中，我有提到一个叫部族祭文的概念。那么在钥匙图腾柱这里，旅行者们还可以开启每个部族的部族祭文了。这个祭文呢，除了包含部族的传说和周边的风土人情以外，还有大家最关心的纳塔的角色传说任务。
哦，
也就是说，包含上述所有内容在内，每一个部族都将陆续开放三个章节供玩家游玩。
所以我们
哦 ，there's gonna be so much content，
有新的形式出现的。
除了部落巨文以外呢，在 5.0 版本还有更多以单元剧形式出现的篇幅比较短的世界任务，比方说刚才介绍到的以小家伙为主角的世界任务。
好好好，那我们一口气介绍了这么多的包括场景啊，包括我们战斗的一些 boss 呀、啊，包括刚才说的任务，那么接下来我们再跟旅行者们介绍一下。
Can you hold your hand showing you where they are? Yes, he will.
那就由我来为大家。
And the new function will show me where they are too. Wow, it's so colorful and bright.
比如纳塔探索的导览，还有前往奇瓦特各处打卡的旅行回顾，完成其中一个活动呢，还能获得一个四星法器。值得一提的是，即使旅行者们已经游玩过的一些挑战呢，在纳塔也会以一个完全不同的形式呈现。
这里我要替他说一句，我们也为旅行者准备了一些
gameplay clips
游玩的短片。具体有多不一样，我们一起看一下就知道。
Tell me more，
就看一看。
Chino also shows. Oh, I missed that.
很多全新的玩法。今天也邀请了几个朋友到现场来实际体验一下。
Security guard.
带着大家跑一段现实挑战。
Why is the security guard here?
龙灵，这是疾风龙部落的。然后我们可以魂附到这个龙灵上，就可以开始我们的挑战了。进去以后呢，开右扳机，你就钻到地下了。在这个过程里面呢，我们需要借助我们这个小龙的特点啊，去尽可能多的吃到金币。
I see. Oh no, fell off accidentally. This is a wrong demonstration.
I have skill issue. Oh, okay, so like the stamina flowers in Sumeru. Good job. Good job, you did it. Oh, they're doing it. Oh no. Oh, she failed. RIP.
咱们教学也就先告一段落，立刻进入比赛，怎么样？
来了，实战环节。
Were those PlayStation controllers?
互相比一下挑战用时和挑战得分。
漏了。
我怎么感觉我上来就漏
了？
我们有戏了。
Thank you for the water, Erdin.
分析。
是不是漏了一个？
那你要相信我，
你转头看看呗。
你漏不了。
哎。
哎。
我怎么感觉我下面又漏了？来，准备到。
He's trying his best, okay?
来了。
This is like what the first WuWa live stream was like, but less awkward.
不愧是我教的呀。
哎。
咱先把它跑。哎，对，回到正轨。可以。
With like the games and stuff.
Oh.
So again, welcome back. PlayStation controls on the screen. Oh, you're so right. Oh, he's crying.
Yeah.
Reminds me of the WoW live stream. It's showing the game and not made up games. Yeah, exactly. It's like the same like competition style, but in stuff that we're actually interested in.
Joe.
Yeah, those are definitely PlayStation controllers. He said, I don't want to do this anymore, you do it. Get a queen. Gamer girl, let's go! It was his fault. It was his fault. Before a security guard pulls up the purchase screen and doxes the dev. Swipes $500.
新鲜的玩法吧，
期待。
旅行者们，欢迎回来。
Sorry.
哇，我终于从逆夜龙的形态解脱了。那坐在我身边的呢，就是大家的老朋友。
Hit the glider just before the floor. I know she knows what she's doing.
大家好。
I didn't catch what her role was in the staff, but hey, Temple! And his second 20 pulls total is pretty good. What's a sanctifying elixir?
那接下来必须还有啊，对对对。
Also, is that a buddy? Is that a pet? Is that a pet for me to come with? Come with me? What's a kaboom box? Please tell me more.
等等。啊，福利的环节为什么就到这里了
？That's what I'm saying.
每年的福利不是
哦，
还有吗？哎，
哦，
难道大伟哥没有跟你讲过吗？啊，他跟我讲什么了？那么。
I said, isn't this what we give out every year? Why would we do anything different?
Michael, you 真不知道吗？
真不知道。
别慌，别慌，别慌。
Oh my God, real? He actually doesn't know.
我和旅行者们一起来一条条分享一下我们这个版本做出的福利以及相关优化。
Okay, I'm ready. I'm sad.
旅行者们只要完成魔神任务《融花与炎日之厨》，也就是我们5.0的主线，就可以在活动界面直接领取额外的500元石。
刚刚说到的是完成主线就
just that one or like
那。还有提到一点是5.0版本期间才有、
yeah.
那是只有5.0才有吗
哎，那可不是了在接下来的5.0 5.1 和5.3版本也就是我们的主线重要篇章发布的这些版本都可以拿到这样的限时奖励也就是有更多的额外的500元石哦
嗯
okay.
我感觉还是有一些吸引力
yeah that's pretty good that's pretty good plus the fate we also get the fate on top of that
在后续的新角色无论他们是以不足祭文还是以传说任务的形式出现他们的故事的时候只要玩家在当前的版本进行了这些任务的体验就可以获得额外的奖励了
那具体有哪些奖励
哎，这些奖励包含额外的原石，以及还有对应角色突破等级二和突破等级三所需要的所有培养材料哦。
Okay, wait. I'm gonna need them to go back. Give me one second.
出现新角色，无论他们是以不足迹闻还是以传说任务的形式，出现他们的故事的时候。
Do they appear as travel chronicles or story quests? As long as players experience these quests in the corresponding version, they receive additional rewards.
那具体有哪些奖励？
哎，这些奖励包含
extra primos
以及。
Level ups for ascension phases 2 and 3. So that's up to 40?
60? Dang!
Yeah, that saves so much resin. Holy!
现在养新角色的这个培养压力就一下子下来了。
没错。
That's really nice. That's really nice.
接触到新角色的时候，就是能铺平很多原先遇到的阻碍。
但是，对于新加入的这些
，Yeah, this is my question for new people. Yeah.
感到纳塔，对于他们有什么样的安排？
那Michael，你的意思是说，假如我是一个
Sorry, sucks to suck.
我没有办法第一时间体会到这些任务，那我就拿不到对应的人事奖励了。这一点我们当然也都考虑到了。
We've considered that and we don't care.
也开放了一个新的功能，是主线。
Okay, quick start.
在5.0版本更新以后，只要完成了璃月的主线魔城任务，并且达到了冒险等级28级，就可以直接在活动界面。
I think that's doable. I mean, Liwei is long, but I think that's doable within a version. Yeah.
最好，那我觉得就是现在了。
哎，我还要给大家补充一条信息哦，就是快速开启的这个功能在后续版本也会陆续。
Going from Liwei to Natlan is weird. I know that's so much lore to skip.
之前忙碌在外的一些旅行者，或许会返回到提瓦特。
Travelers have been busy.
那对于我们这些回归的老朋友，是不是也应该有些表示啊？
你知道在原神原先的版本里面有
Cell Reunion, Cell Reunion Update, New Cell Reunion, something different.
那么在 5.0 版本呢，我们对新之光环的奖励也做了一定的调整。除了原本的原始奖励以外呀，还有一些长期没有回归到提瓦特的旅行者们。那这些旅行者呢，还会额外在新之光环活动中领取至多10枚纠缠之源。
十抽啊！
对，具体的参与规则呢，旅行者可以
Shut up right now
和游戏内的指引
等等。那新玩家跟老朋友都照顾到了，
没错、啊。
那像我这种一直坚守在提瓦特
里，Ten wishes for Stellar Reunion. Are you so for real right now？
想法，那有没有针对我们的一些内容呢
？Does that make Stellar Reunion worth？
其实原神的开发者吧，
worth not playing for 2 weeks。
关注和倾听玩家的反馈。那么接下来我还有更多的
，Okay, yeah, give me more. I'm ready.
反馈做出的，在5.0版本更新以后呢？
Listen, I was ready for anything. I was ready for anything at this point.
不知道大家有没有注意过啊？就是区域特展一直有一个
View only non-clickable recommendation for found in the wild location recommendations. Oh, okay, this is the.
推荐，
没错。
对，那么现在呢？只要你点击了这个选项，它就会在大地图上自动
Yeah, that thing.
It
looks so nice too.
不仅如此
，This is great. I love it.
这个自动追踪功能来监控这些区域里面剩余特产的可采集数量。
哇，那也太舒服了吧！那怪物。
How many do we get from dailies? With Welkin, it's 150. Without Welkin, it's 60.
那么在这一次啊，我们也针对这样的一个反馈做了一些调整。在5.0版本更新以后呢，我们
Welkin from Liwei to Natlan without being ever super right.
其中啊，就包括 Michael 你刚才提
到的drop rates.
那怎么样提升？
大家可以看到我们视频上面的一些
comparison of the drop materials in our video.
好明显。
Holy, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Can we also increase from zero to something when they drop nothing? Okay, we're level 9. Yep.
世界等级九吗？
没错。那大家会想啊，世界等级九会不会非常困难？但是对于这些实力强大的旅行者
，Oh, we have to do the trial. Oh man, I haven't done a trial in so long.
会获得更丰厚的掉落奖励。我必须要强调一下，这些掉落奖励包含
having being able to get the free rewards
for the free materials and the increased drop rates.
Yeah.
A person whose name is Gibberish, thank you for the follow, welcome in.
难道你不觉得
那这样吧我还有一些痛点就我必须要今天就替玩
家 I must speak up for players today
我也一直
觉得 OK alright OK
那你们有安排吗
那当然了那当然了
The way he's tapping the table like Give me artifacts Give me artifacts
主要是吐槽两个点啊就是第一个点叫圣遗物转狗粮第二个点叫一个极品圣遗物的胚子我们先说圣遗物分解的事情啊。
Freaking go! Oh my gosh! Thank you! Thank you! God! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Thank you! Oh my god! Oh my god! Thank you! Oh
my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh
my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh把它拿掉
Thank you, Honkai, sorry
我的背包是一直满的状态
对然后存着的时候呢你又
For being our test subject
把它直接换成魔蓝
对万一后面有角色要用到
What if I need the Ver character later? Bro is me, I am him
那么提了一个很重要的问题啊就是他如果到了关键的时候却又没有办法为后续的角色获取对应的圣遗物就会感觉自己很矛盾
对
不对
对的
那么除了圣遗物转化为培养材料以外
Are we gonna get custom,
重磅的功能
Strongbox?
助圣之霜
Sanctifying Elixir
这个名字听起来有点厉害
这个名字听起来很厉害它的功能
A typewriter
旅行者们可以通过使用助圣
之霜 There we go
来兑换指定词条的圣遗物
指定词条吗
Dude, main sets and subsets?
这个指定词条不仅能够指定主词条的属性种类还可以额外指定两个副词条的属性
副词条也能
没错
那我的双爆岂不是
对跟你想的一样5.0 版本的铸圣之霜呢大家可以通过萃取一定
是
已经升级的圣遗物或者说探索纳塔的
I swear every time HSR has something like better they just one up it
刚才我们是不是有提到周年庆的邮件奖励
啊对
所以在周年庆的邮件奖励当中我们也附
上 And artifact type, wait, I want to go back and look at the interface again.
或者说探索那本的铸圣之霜
我的双爆岂不是
副词条的属性条不进呢
Okay, yeah, so you can pick piece, set, main stat, and two substats. That's insane. That is insane. Bruh.DPS that scales with HP healing percentage of waiting for you. It doesn't make it a two-liner? I'm not sure. That's a good question. If it's just two. I wouldn't think so that it would make it just two. I would think it would make it at least three. I cried when I saw this. You still have to roll it. It reveals the new artifact set. Oh, let me read. While the equipping characters in Night Soul's Blessing... Okay, so that state they were talking about is on the field. The damage dealt is increased by 15%.After equipping character consumes one night's soul point while on field, crit rate increases by 40% for 6 seconds. This effect can trigger once every second. Great. So this is Natlan Marashose, basically. Got it. Awesome. Bottom right, no, left, and cost. Cost 4. Each set can be defined one time. Time remaining this cycle, 18 days, 8 hours. Okay, so you get one chance per artifact set.Per like month, I'm guessing. Afro Thunder, welcome back with my poopy substats. Chazzy, welcome to chat. How are you? Cost 4, one from anniversary. I wonder how easy these will be to get. Yeah, they might make it difficult to get with how nice it, like, this is very, very, very nice. So I wouldn't be surprised if there was, in fact, quite a few strings attached. And they might, you might need to save these up quite a bit. But it's, in my brain, I see it as like a, you've been farming this domain for months and months and you simply just cannot get this one piece. Like it's just not happening. And you have these things saved up and then you use that to get that piece and then you're done with the domain. Like that's kind of how my brain is
like you still have to do the work, put in the work to farm your artifacts, but it's less of that like hopeless feeling of like I will never get this piece, and then blah 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 blah. Anyways, let's continue. Magic Man, welcome to chat. Hello.
副词条也能
没错, 那我的 goblet costs 4, other costs less like 2 or 1. Oh yeah, I imagine the other pieces like flowers and feathers.
已经升级的圣遗物, 或者说探索纳塔的大世界,
或者说 hold on, what was that? 萃取一定数... use as an extraction material. Extract sanctifying elixir. Be obtained by extracting a certain number of upgraded artifacts. Oh, but I want to use that for fodder. I don't want to do that. I'm too stingy with my fodder, man. I guess if you have to, though. If you have to. Middle bottom? Wait, where? Middle bottom? What do you mean middle bottom? Same, you mean on the right side? Middle right? Can't be a hoarder anymore? Well, it's... Listen. You mean I can't be a hoarder anymore? I can still hoard it. Kelly craft one in 18 days. Yeah, or whatever the time will be. You're gonna have to let some go. I do let things go. I'm very good. I'm good at not hoarding in Genshin. I hoard more in HSR because I know less about the artifacts. Onset Power Goblet for Father with double crits, real. One top 1% Arlecchino. I only need to go up like 300 spots or something. Surely I can do it. You hoarded for this update, Massive Brain. For a month or patch if you buy a battle pass. F2P has to wait at least one patch to make one. Maybe. I don't know. Hard to say. We might get them from other places too. Two per patch crafted and then more in battle pass and expiration. Yes, that would be math, I think. My hoarding in HSR is a problem, real, because there's also so many more, like, substats and things. Try about HP bar next scene. Okay, let's, there's more to see. Imagine you misclicked. That would be fire.
Yay, thank you.
For to battle pass? I saw the HP bar. That's what I meant when I said fire. Sorry. I wasn't very clear. Wait, but did you want me to look at something else? I don't hoard ever. I spend until I'm broke. See? And we just have two different ways of playing the game, you know? That's okay. Oh, not okay. Did he just say you get extra from Gnostic Him? Oh, it's just from that. Okay, got it. This guy's genuinely excited because apparently he didn't know. Meaning the items in our battle pass rewards are no longer useful to them, including a surplus of 40 rewards. Dude, I have so many freaking rocks, you have no idea. Talents of characters from certain nations already maxed out. Yeah. Can we do the HSR thing, please? Please. I don't want to have to pick anymore. Like, that's so much brain energy. Directly use this plan for subsequent battle pass. So you can just pick from any of them. Okay, that's not as nice as I wanted it to be, but... This guy is so funny. I love him. He's so the player base. Have I set a level of the statue to 7.10 and leeway to the max? Wait, hold on. To increase the stamina limit. Self-aware they are.
Mm-hmm. 你觉得这个问题该不该解决? 对啊，不然玩家直接到了纳塔。
Michael the Goat, I do love him.
He's
like, you're telling me that you're talking about Genshin Impact right now.
快速开启，那么一定要把相关的所有的细节
都
从5.0版本更新开始，旅行者们就可以通过。
I would be able to increase the stamina by offering statues of 7 of any region. Oh, it just caps whenever you.Oh, that's really smart, actually.
像枫丹路景泉这样的纳塔独有的供奉系统，也将会提供更多的原始奖励。哎，我帮大家算了一下，上述这些。
I wonder if we're gonna offer stuff to the Sacred Flame.
有超过十枚纠缠之源的。
Or if it'll be like something in each tribe.
居然又多了十抽，
没错。
The sigils.
感觉我现在也有点动力要去探索大世界了。
嗯。
More motivated to explore.
你希不希望
Do you want it to be done?
He
said I can stop talking if you want.
是啊，
那当然是。
你还给我留了，
我还留。
Oh, he's got a secret card in his butt.
Michael, 你要知道啊，或者我们的旅行者大家要知道，一般节目的高潮啊都要留到后面的，所以到迄今为止我都还没有收到重量级的信息。
哎，大伟哥来之前完全没有跟我说过。
Oh, he doesn't love me.
那么这次我也不做。
Ooh, surprise cards. Okay.
Michael,
three surprise cards. What will it be? Chat, stop telling me I'm not ready. I prepared myself for anything. I'm prepared for.
Okay, 好。
I'm not gonna say anything, but I prepared for everything.
刚才啊，我们有一位朋友说到过，希望他能够把玩家歪小保底的。不好的运气都转到他身上，对吧？
Jake,
我们也很佩服这位
Did Jake save us?
的勇气。但是接下来我要公布的
，No, you're not. Stop. You're gonna make me stubborn.
可以些微的分担一下这位旅行者的负担。Michael, 你想不想替各位旅行者先体验一下？
那我就替各位旅行者先验验货了啊。
那么麻烦我们的工作人员。好，谢
谢。
谢谢
win, 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 win! What the frick was that? Why did it explode?
This is what we have in the 5.0 version of the character creation event, called Are they getting rid of
the 50-50? What is this? Let me explain
to
you. That is, when the players often say the small bag comes, there is a chance that they will meet the Are they getting rid of the 50-50?当这次事件出现的时候呢，抽取的结果必定为当期的 UP 五星角色。
但是哦，我比较好奇啊，这个事件会挤占以前的大小保底的概率吗？
哎，知道你就会这么问，我相信旅行者们也非常关心这样一个问题。那么捕获明光，它关键就关键在它只是单纯提高了小保底抽中当期 UP 的机会，
well, yeah.
并不会影响这个游戏其他所有的概率规则。
If it's guaranteed, then
也就是说，你简单理解为我们抽中当期 UP 的。概率提高了，就这么简单。
这个
okay, so from what I understand, if you get a fifth, if you get a five star, you're on a 50-50, you have a chance to for something to happen that will make it okay. You have your 50-50 chances, but there is a also a separate chance that you will just like auto win.Our chances raise up to 55% win, 45% loss. It's like a spoiler, you won the fifth. Oh, the special effect. Oh, okay. They explained it badly. I understood it. I could see how some people would be confused, but I think I get it. It's like a second chance. There's a chance that you have a chance to win.Okay, I got it. So it's a 5% chance that you'll get the insta win?
Michael, 你觉得这个消息都不算爆炸性消息是吗？
我觉得已经挺爆炸了。
Every 50-50, you lose your chances on your next 50-50 get better. If you lose 50-50 and get the guaranteed after the next 50-50, you have 55-45.So if I win my 50-50 normally, do I still have the 55-45? It's only for 5.0? That's not right. Check the Genshin chat in Discord. Hold on. I want to make sure I don't... I don't say anything incorrect here. Oh my god, what is this? Stop. Hold on. What is their whole graphic? I can't. Okay. All right, chat, let's learn. He said in 5.0. From 5.0, probably starting in 5.0, I would assume. 5051. Nouvellet. Great. 5050 lost. Second chance. 10% won. Saved. 90% lost. Really lost. This doesn't help. I'm so sorry. So you can only get Nouvellet now. If you win your 50-50, you will get Nouvellet. More confusing for me. Also more confusing for me. I think, well, not more confusing, but just, I thought you guys were saying it was 5%, not 10%. But the math may be mathing differently. It does nothing much else except tell you it's already early, it's already won. It's basically just a better chance. I think in 50-50, in 5.0, you can lose twice in a row. No. It's the same. It's like, if you lose, you're still guaranteed. Do we know whether the special event consumes or keeps guarantee yet? I think it consumes it. They said that if you have a guarantee, you use the guarantee. It's only for if you're on a 50-50. Not only for 5.0 and forward. Initial 50-50, but if you were going to lose, there's another 10% chance after the initial 50% to get the character that you want. 50-50 has been buffed. 55-45. Before the animation plays, the game knows if you lost the 50-50. The game rolls a 10% chance to get the on-banner character and then plays the new animation. If you get it over a long period of time, this will be a 55-45 ratio for people. 50-50 shot with a 10% save makes a save of 5% overall quick maths. Okay, thank you, math people. So this is standard banner only. No, I don't think so. It showed it on Milani banner. Okay, Slay, I mean, overall, like, it's a good thing. Like, I... overall, beneficial. I mean, it wouldn't be standard banner only because there's no 50-50 on standard banner. Limited banner only. If you lose the 50-50, you have a 10% chance of skipping the failure. Saying, not, I'd win. That's kind of fun, too, because there's, like, a special animation. So it's like, ooh, I was gonna lose, but I didn't. 5% is a lot. Yeah, 5% is a lot. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. All right, okay. Thank you, chat, for helping me and others understand. I'm going to continue the video. We're going to watch them do it again. Oh no, he's doing the weapon. Wait! No way, shut up, bruh. Oh my god, weapon banner worth? Weapon banner worth just in time for me to pull for Arlecchino weapon? Holy! Weapon banner actually good? This reveals 4 stars for the first half. Got... Ugh, okay. Okay. I won't say anything. Pause. Shinyan actually being good with someone or just there for fun? Also, Bennett. Show me 4 stars for a weapon, please. It's fine. Skippable. Skippable. I love her catalyst, it's so pretty. Why did it become one? I really, really hope that this guy, not knowing any of this information, Michael,
is true. Because that's so funny. Based on my impression of the devs, stop it. You should write what you were ready for to prove the non-believers wrong. It's less than like I'm saying I predicted everything and more that just I was very prepared for crazy things to happen. I'm not saying I could have predicted any of this, especially the 50-50 loss save, because it's so complicated. But that's what I'm trying to tell you guys. But it's okay. Free 5-star.
难道说？没错。那么在今天呢？
我在这里去公布我们这一次5.0前瞻节目最后一条福利。You can't not.
也就是从今年开始,
there you go. Okay, alright. See? Ha! 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 Take that!
已经解锁了祈愿系统的所有旅行者,
doubters?
免费获取分行世间祈愿包含的任意一名,
I will get Tignari, I guess. I don't know. I did not watch this! I haven't been on Twitter all day! Every year? Oh, sick. One per year, bro. That's crazy. More standard characters? Did he just say guaranteed there's gonna be more standard characters? Bro is so excited. Wait, who's gonna go on standard? Maybe finally Geo, standard Geo? Maybe Shilinen? Let's give Michael some time to calm down.
原神这个游戏的开发者,
oh, the heartstrings music.
原神的玩家, 这一点一直从1.0开始,
Kinich. I'll take a free Kinich every year.
玩家提出的一切的问题, 我们作为玩家当然也都是感同身受的,
是的,
因为原神, all of them? 接下来要走的路也很困难, 也很长, 嗯, 但是我希望它能够一直延伸下去, 嗯, 我们能够一直走下去, 也离不开大家一直以来的持续关注和支持。
45 minutes left.
就到了Michael的回合了。
If Oracle didn't pull Gene earlier, I'd be screaming with him right now, real. But at least now Oracle can get a free Gene every year.
我们想带给大家的其实很简单。旅行者们能够收获一些简单的快乐,我们就非常满足了。我们平时也非常重视每位旅行者的声音。我觉得像很多大家其实都是发自内心的。Magic
Man, thank you for the follow. Welcome. Feel free to scream anyway. That's very exciting. I'm gonna get some more Tignari cones, and then I guess whoever they add. If it's someone I want, then I'll take them too. Lumi on standard Vader, Capitano on standard. Let's watch some interesting short clips. Okay. Yeah, we can do that. It's fine. Oh, my boy. Ooh. Oh, this is so... like... it's giving, like, cyberpunk, kind of. Oh, I love him. Yeah, kind of one PC too, yeah. Oh, it's so colorful. Oh, pretty. Wow. They really are going crazy with their use of colors. Like, oh my goodness. Ooh, get him. It's the chunk boy.
Blaze to Natlan. Cool. Good job. Good job, guys. That was great. Oh my god, new Archon art! Oh, look at them! Oh my god! Oh, and Mavika's lighting the candles! I love how they all have little fruits. And like Zhongli has the chocolate. Oh my god. Oh, why is she sticking her butt like that? Cause it's cute. Only Sarita is missing. You're so right. You're so right. Archon sent Fiorina. Fiorina honorary Archon. Oh my god. Cute. She does deserve it, yes. She deserves everything. Imagine in theater. Tell me more.
我们非常关注玩家对这些内容的建议，并且啊，有很多玩家的建议其实给了我们迭代的灵感。嗯，所以我们从 4.8 开始就一直在对这个玩法进行调整。那在接下来即将更新的 5.0 版本当中呢，我们全量重新设计了。
Redesign the Wonder Spoons, okay, better?
注意事件。
Question mark?
在新的版本当中呢，这些事件将根据当期的
Clear strategies
所对应的反应体系进行有效清晰的策略引导。简单来讲，就是你拿到这个注意的时候，就已经知道它
应该用什么样的东西了。 kind of team to use it with.
老实说，之前这些 buff 我都看得不是很明白。没错没错，这也是很真实的一个玩家反应。
是的，
那这些注意事件呢，也将提供非常强大的特殊元素反应机制，也就是他们是贴合原有的反应体系去制作的。即使玩家
对自己
手头能够出战的角色机制不够了解，他也能够简单的通过元素搭配来展开有效的进攻策略。
That's nice. Yeah, because not everybody like. Sorry, I'm just gonna pause to for short. Yeah, not really. Yeah, but because Imaginarium Theater presents a way to build your account very horizontally, which is not what most people are used to doing with their account in Genshin. A lot of people don't study how to play every single character. They're very correct in that. So just having like a brief overview of generally what do I need to be doing with these characters is, yeah, it's smart.
当然了，可能会有玩家会问啊，那如果你们设置了这么强大的体系增益之后，会不会导致这些玩法越发的没有挑战性？所以在 5.0 版本呢，我们对于追求更高难度的挑战者，也会开启新的卓越模式。
Even harder.
所对应的奖励内容也会增加，所以也希望玩家能够持续的对我们后续推出的玩法不断的。
Oh, how exciting! Oh, wonderful. Okay, yes. Because there were definitely people that said it was too easy.Oh, Fremenae card. Dude, I want the TCG cards IRL just to have them. And the dice. I want the dice. Niblet is like the co-archon. Yeah, Niblet is... Oh, pretty! Genshin X Lodge Attack? No, wait, is that Nayaka Chair? Is that real?
联名产品信息，此外还有多种联名周边可以获取。各位旅行者喜欢的话，千万不要错过。哇，罗技的定制款，哎，你要知道我从小到大用的都是罗技的外
套，这个
太酷了。嗯 ，Michael， 听说你今天应该还给大家带来了
music。
是的，give me 音乐也必须。
Give me a concert。
分享。
Give me a concert。Give it to me.
音乐风格跟枫丹相比起来是要特殊的非常多的。
Give it to me.
接下来就请旅行者们拿起手边的
peanuts, sunflower seeds, drinks and water. Do you guys have peanuts or sunflower seeds? Because I don't. So if you guys need to share, you can share and bake up peanuts. Oh yes! I'm turning it up. Oh yes.Oh, oh. Any knowers on language? It's beautiful. Oh, I can hear the melody of the song from the teaser. Get it, conductor man. Nigerian Yoruba. Ooh, pretty. Pretty. Hop off? I just know I'm gonna get emotional, man. I just know there's gonna be a cutscene where something like this hits my eardrums and I'm gonna start sobbing. I can hear the trauma. Oh, man. The emotional damage. The lyrics are so pretty too. Wow. Oh my god. That was beautiful. Okay, now we're gonna get into a bop. All right, give me the bop. This is my favorite part of every year. I can't. Oh, I've seen one of those before. Okay, yeah. Battle music? Combat music? When are you going to a Genshin concert? When I
can afford it. There's never one near me, so I have to travel so far. It's so sad. They don't like Texas, which, like, valid, but, you know. There's so many vocals, I love it! Ooh! This is languages I recognize. This is so cool. So they are they using multiple different languages? They really never miss, man. It's just, I mean, they know how to cook. I don't know what that little thing was, but it was cool. That. Anybody know what that's called? Hi, Bloxy. It was like a tiny little shoulder drum. I love it. I love this. I love these vocals. It's so good. It's called the Tiny Little Shoulder Drum. Like, it's so good. Yeah, the girls. Oh, they're eating this up. Yay! That was beautiful! Oh my god!
Wow.
That was so epic.
But
like I was in a movie.
Using
HP while stancing. Too distracted by the music. My whole team dies. So this is actually the ending of the story. And
it's
a huge lord.
You
got one nation left.
And then 因为上述的原因越来越紧密。
那么鸡哥也给我们介绍了很多原神未来的规划，那么也是让我们对未来啊充满着期待。我们今天的那个前瞻特别节目啊，到这里呢也就接近尾声了。那原神到现在啊都已经4年了，我也有很多心里话啊想跟我们旅行者讲。我们一起从2020年的那个秋天启程呢，已经是相伴的走过了4个年头，
共
度过了许多难忘的时刻。那随着这个探索的步伐不断前行啊，那提瓦特的这个大陆也是愈加的这个丰富多彩。那我也相信未来的每一片新的地域啊，每一段新的故事啊，会成为我们最美好的这个回忆啊。那过去的这一年啊，原神项目组和我、啊、都是曾经经历了这个焦虑和迷茫的。我们听到了很多的声音啊，有的把原神吹上天，有的把原神啊贬得一无是处啊。这样的声音多了啊，难免让项目组和我都有点不知所措。我自己回想起原神这一路走来啊，其实旅行者的热情、期望与反馈啊，让我们有了不断前行的这个动力啊，也是原神啊能够不断进步的这个源泉。于是啊，今年上半年啊，原神项目组和我、啊、决定去跟世界各地的旅行者面对面聊聊。我们去了很多我们从来没有去过的城市，比如湖北襄阳啊，比如巴西圣保罗啊。在跟全球各地的旅行者面对面的时候啊，每一位旅行者都非常激动地跟我们分享他们的提瓦特旅程啊。他们有的还在每天体验原神，有的呢只是新版本更新上来体验一下，有的呢已经很久没有来过提瓦特。跟他们聊完呢、啊、制作组和我重新理解了旅行的意义啊。我们的脑子里啊想起了那句啊，我们终将重逢、啊、我们意识到啊，只有对旅行者的陪伴是原神唯一不能改变的，其他一切皆可改变啊。也正是因为有了各位旅行者啊，我们才有机会在未来带来更多精彩优质的内容。最后呢，我们将在8月28日迎来全新的5.0版本火之国纳塔。那这片炙热而神秘的土地啊，也是等待着每一位勇敢的旅行者前去探索。感谢大家一直以来的支持与陪伴，愿你们的纳塔之旅充满惊喜与期待。旅行者们，我们纳塔见。
Thank you, Dawei. Thank you very much. What's that say? What's that say? I can't read Chinese. What does that say?
我感觉他们很放松，比我们之前这个，我在场的时候要轻松很多。
He's so funny, Star.
怎么回事？
Nat Lan Soon, OK.
还有不是跟我说是综艺效果吗？怎么整的是我啊？
啊，我不知道，龙龙不知道，我只是一条孽龙，你要来找我、啊，大尾龙要我干的，哎呀，找到大尾龙去啊！
我不在的时候，他们谈笑风生。
哟，好玩吗？
好玩，咋了？
像不像 bug 单？
像你的 bug 单，拿着吧你。
我就看你还是没有你 bug。
修完了，
走走走，赶紧回去修 bug 去，
看你修 bug。
Oh, it's a bug. Oh, a bug list of things to fix.Oh, yay!
Hello, travelers, and welcome to Tibet Talks.
Startup?
I'm Zach、
okay.
Aguilar, voice of Ether, co-hosting Fish with、yogurt. my friend and voice of Albedo, Koi Dao.
Koi!、
Huh. Friend, huh?
The best friends.
Like that one time you played Wind Trace without me?
Oh! oh.
Hey, everyone! Genshin Impact invited us to be part of the 4th、oh. anniversary、
Tea.
celebration this year. 4 years.That's crazy.
That is crazy.
Oh, I can't believe it's been so long.
I know.
These past 4 years, I've had the pleasure of delivering some epic grunt sounds as Aether,、mm. voicing、
yep.
emotional dialogue in the Archon quests, and working
on the
special
programs. You
guys
got some yummy drinks going on there.
So many great memories have been made, not only working on the game, but also playing it.
Well, they didn't show us any of the new food.
Oh my gosh, 4 years.
I、wow. can't wait to see、you、that.
Know, I turned 4 years old once. It was awesome. Back then, I never thought I'd
Koi,
get the voice、
stop.
of a cool、
I、can't
and intelligent
with you.
character in an exciting game like Genshin Impact. We know that many of our fellow castmates have had some fun, sometimes truly unbelievable experiences over the past 4 years. So let's bring in a few special guests.
I will stand by the、
too.
Fact that Koi Dao is one of the funniest cast members in Genshin Impact.
Turn
I love
the unknown
him.
Into the known.
Let's do
King.
it.
King.
Let's go.
King.
happy four-year
Kimberly!
I'm Kimberly Ann Campbell, the voice of Nahida. And I know what you're thinking. A lot of people are like, wow, you sound so different from Nahida. One time during a rare live stream for me, someone in the chat told me to prove that I was actually the voice of Nahida.
Stop.
So both online and in person at conventions, I get a handful of people who seem to be very surprised that that voice.
Yeah,
comes
it's almost
out
like she's an adult.
What can I say? It's
with an adult voice.
I usually whip out a everyone hold hands to prove I'm not lying.
She's so she
yeah,
really called him out. She
like,
said stop.
I usually just scream Windblade at people to prove that it's me.
That works.
Or make a huh sound.
Or even just in your private moments.
Yeah.
I've heard you scream it.
Exactly. I turn to my right side and I scream Windblade. It helps scare away the demons.
That's weird. You're a weird guy.
Anyways, here's more guests.
I'm so lucky that I get to see a lot of Genshin Impact fans and cosplayers, especially the Raiden Shogun cosplayers, at conventions
so
all over
That's
the world.
Weird. You're a weird
it's so
guy.
When fans come up to my table and realize that I.
Hi, Anne. I love you
like
so
that.
Much. You're amazing.
So someone will come up and say, oh, are you the voice of Raiden Shogun? Oh, yeah, that's me. Can you do a line? And I'll be like, Inazuma shines eternal. And watching their eyes light up always makes me smile.
Oh.
Genshin Impact fans are so passionate, and I love you guys.
She's so sweet.
I personally
we
have
love
a lot
Anne.
To celebrate.
Hi, Keith.
When Genshin Impact dropped, almost immediately, my life began to change in a measurable way. I began to meet more and more people online, at conventions, and honestly, in my daily life, who are so passionate about this game. And I've learned that I love to sneak up on Genshin Impact cosplayers, and then when I'm right behind them, say something like, this is an age of gods and monsters. I wish not for dominion, yet I cannot watch the common folk suffer.
That's such dad behavior, I'm sorry.
The reactions are genuinely priceless. And I frequently hear from people online that that was one of the highlights of their con.
Aww.
I meet people that are so excited about this game that they literally tear up. I mean, honestly, how lucky am I to be a part of something like that?
Aw, that's so sweet.
Wow.
And that is such a funny thing to do at conventions. Can you imagine?
That was such an Owen Wilson
And suddenly speaking in voice. Except I just get really shy.
Yeah.
Who else we got?
Okay, first off, I want to give a big
oh
thank
god,
you to
hi, Ray.
For letting me play the most beautiful man I have ever seen.
Real.
Seriously,
you're so real for that.
A prized character of mine.
Oh,
one
man.
I'm just so excited to play and dig into for years
thank
to
you,
come.
Ray.
Well, he does have a range of
so
subtle
anyways.
Emotional beats and some true cathartic twists. Nothing about him can possibly compare to the elephant seal in the room. The month of Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale changed
yep.
my life forever. I've seen that coming. Genshin Impact fans are so polite whenever I meet
oh
them.
Oh my god,
whenever
he said the thing.
Say it, but of course, I always do. And their gratitude about, he said the thing.
Yeah.
is always a palpable delight.
Oh.
Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale. Thank you.
Beautiful.
He said the thing.
Stunning.
He said the thing.
He said the thing.
Say the thing. You say the thing.
That is my ringtone. That's a good idea. Whoa, well, Zach, pause. Zach, pause. I knew that you could do that, but I'm gonna need you to do that again.
You say the thing.
Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale.
Zach, what the heck?
Oratrice
who are you?
D'Analyse Cardinale.
Ooh, nice French Yippee. Accent, Koi.
So who's the most beautiful man you've ever seen, Zach? There's a correct answer.
When I looked into your eyes, Koi.
Mm-hmm. Go on.
I knew. That the most beautiful man I ever saw was the reflection in your eyes, me!
I knew it. I knew it. I knew that's where it was going.
Flip.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah.
I'm obsessed with
coming,
that,
everybody. And what an awesome 4 years of Genshin Impact.
So much happened.
It's like...
Yeah,
we've got
Zach Angelar
store, so
to Koi Dao is the same that
Tivat
Caleb
talks.
Is to so Nicholas.
All right.
It's like the same chemistry interaction.
Welcome to Tibat Talks. I'm Sarah Miller Cruz, the English voice girls. Of the movie, and joining me are my lovely co-hosts.
I'm not just being Crystal homophobic. Why?
Hi, everybody. Crystal Lee here. I voice Clarand, the legendary champion duelist herself. Pew, pew, pew.
And you do a great job of it.
It is me. I have returned. It is Jenny Okobori.
I love Jenny.
I am the voice of Yoimiya. And I hope this anniversary sparks joy with all of you out there.
I see what you did there.
Speaking of the anniversary, how are you two celebrating this amazing milestone?
Oh, one heck Cuties. Of a milestone. 4 years? That's like enough to get a bachelor's degree. I mean, I'm going to celebrate my graduation from Genshin Impact University.
Amen. We've learned so much. It basically is a college degree.
I haven't planned anything specific yet, but I'm sure I'll play more Genshin Impact as usual. Come on, you've been in this game since the beginning.
You should see your twin, Sarah.
Nothing? No, listen.
You should see your twin.
I've been looking for him for 4 long years. Okay.
I've been skipping classes. I'm not graduating.
Crystal, you mentioned that you're going to graduate. I think I'm going to enroll in grad school so I can stay here for as long as I can.
Yes.
Valid. Valid.
I mean, that's
multiple gap years.
Yeah. Also, stop.
Maxie, thank you for the follow. Welcome in.
I am very much a person that is motivated by sweet little treat culture, and so I just want to know when my next sweet little treat's going to be, and I think I want to indulge in a cake. I want to get one of the Genshin Impact birthday cakes that they send you on your birthday. It's 4 years of looking at them, and I want one.
Yes. Oh my god, about time.
Anyway.
And I want one.
Let's go ahead and turn to our guests and see what they have to say about this moment.
Dude, getting one of those custom-made would be so expensive, but so fun.
Happy anniversary, Yori! I'm so humbled to be part of such a vast world and talented cast. When I auditioned for Chiori, I felt such a connection to her inner strength as a fellow AFAB business owner, who is often told they are intimidating, who was discouraged at the beginning of their career, and who has big aspirations. Throughout the recording, Chiori has continued
to love when the VAs can, like, relate to the character style that they play.
And I hope to have brought a bit of me to you all through her.
And their stories. Like Firefly. Oh my god.
That is so sweet.
Wait, that's lovely.
I love that.
I love Brittany.
That is so great. That's an amazing answer. I really love how, like, Genshin Impact shows a lot of really strong women, you know? Like, a business owner as, like, being one of such example. That's
I will never regret pulling Chiori.
Yes.
I will never regret.
And I feel like a lot of us do feel such connections to our characters, and that's partially what I think, you know, like, helps us
really connect,
bring them to life. You know what I mean? I feel like I'm a lot like Lumine because I also have a twin brother in real life.
Stop.
Yeah, so it's one of the reasons that recording for the We Are Reunited quest is, like, so special.
You just can't find him anywhere.
Honestly, I've gotten teary-eyed basically every single time we've recorded Ether and Lumine getting to be together again, because I really cannot imagine how horrible it would be to be separated from my twin brother. It just,
stop.
Like, makes me so emotional.
Sarah.
It's one of the reasons that when our amazing director was giving me direction for the opening cutscene where they get separated, it actually made me cry. The end.
Sarah just dropping the most heartbreaking stuff.
I love to laugh.
Amber!
You can tell. And I love to laugh as Farina, especially. Some of my
favorite
moments involve doing her variety of laughs. I also kept cracking up later on when she's directing and shouts, "Action!" I had so much fun doing those in a variety of ways.
Dude, I cannot even imagine how much fun Farina would be to voice.
Some of the sillier ones, you know the ones. On the other side of the spectrum, one of my favorite scenes I got to do was when Farina was on stage, reliving all those different moments from her past up to the current day. I'm not joking when I say I couldn't stop crying in the booth while recording those.
Yeah.
Legit. Tears for days.
Yeah. I believe it. I believe it. Oh. She does sound like Fossilor in her normal voice, yeah.
That's a lot of tears today. That's a lot of my God. I know. I guess
McLaurin
I'm
crying.
Made them emotional.
Right.
gosh.
I'm just like, I'm gonna keep saying this because just because I love so much of our cast, but I'm like, I love Amber, and
yes, she's
also, like,
amazing.
It's very true. Like, she does love to laugh. She's a close friend of mine, and I can confirm that. So I feel like Farina was just made for her.
And so I cursed her.
And it's like the way that a lot of people match up with their characters and relate mm-hmm. so well, it's one of the most incredible things. And like, seriously, Farina has yeah. some of the cutest laughs
yes.
ever.
Absolutely agree. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Well, okay. I mean, back to the question though. What about you, Jenny?
Okay, so I mean, my first job when I moved out to LA was actually being a pyrotechnician.
Shut up.
Are you serious? That's amazing.
What? I had such a blast, pun fully intended, by the way, at that job, and it really helped shape who I am. And I honestly feel like Yoimi and I were kind of meant for each other.
How do they do this? How do they job scout like this so well?
Working with fireworks too. Yoimi and I are extremely bubbly and very talkative, as you guys have probably picked
seeking
up on by now.
Seeking voice actors with experience in pyrotechnics or firework characters.
The most meaningful similarity is the love we both feel for our disabled
like, what?
My father has since passed, but I grew up as a primary caretaker for my father who had Alzheimer's.
Bro!
So seeing Yoimi interact and help her father really struck a chord with me. Yeah. I'm getting a little bit choked up.
Oh,
I love
it's literally
so
the same story, man.
Yoimi honestly means more to me than I could ever.
You live in your walls. I mean, really good agent.
Friends,
honestly, dude.
Included, because of this opportunity that I've gotten to voice her, including her Japanese voice actor, who I got to meet last year, and she was so lovely.
Oh, amazing!
Oh my gosh! And I've also just seen so much of the world through conventions. Yeah. It's such an unbelievable honor to lend my voice to Yoimi.
I'm looking for a female voice actor with twin brother.
Who's a character that just brings joy to so many people all over the world.
You do such a
beautiful please provide proof
job
that you
it.
Are a twin.
Thank you.
When I was cast as
Erica,
Venti, I was like, I'm so excited to be a bard because I love singing. Yay! So for the Vinlesa Fest, Venti keeps talking about how he's rehearsing this big song and that he's going to perform it at the end of the event, and he keeps saying the word song. So when we got to that final performance, I was like, hey, just for funsies, since we're running ahead of schedule, can I do a version where I sing at the end just for fun?
Aww.
And the team was like, sure, if you can come up with a tune really quick, we can do it just for fun. So I went on break for like 5 minutes and came back with a little tune for the lyrics and then recorded it.
You wrote a song?
It was super fun, but I didn't expect them to actually use it in the game.
Oh,
like I've said 5,000 times, it was just for fun. And so when the event came out and people started excitingly tagging me in posts about Venti singing, I was so shocked and so excited. Oh my gosh. And it was just so sweet to see how much Venti singing meant to the fans. Like, the reactions were so heartwarming, and I was just
like, they wrote the story
so
based
happy.
On that. Yeah, it's like they like interviewed the VAs
the
about their lives and was like, okay,
no,
this is the character now.
To his pretty poetry too. I'm just really happy that I got to sing at least once in the game.
No.
Oh. Wait, yeah. What? That's oh incredible. Gosh. She just came up with the tune? Like,
yeah. All the Venti VAs sing a song? Oh, yeah, that's a good question. I wonder.
Is it Erica for you? I mean,
I
like,
know,
listen.
I know. And, like, I don't know if y'all have heard the Venti song from that event. But
it was cute.
It's so good.
It was
Erica
good.
Did such an amazing job.
That's
incredible. One
she's
take,
so
5 minutes.
She's so stinking talented. She really is.
She's so talented.
And the fact that she
crazy.
Wrote that, too.
I know. Oh well, okay, so we've been hearing about how all these people feel like a connection to their character, and I was wondering, Crystal, if
oh.
you have an answer to that.
Oh my gosh. Ooh, juicy.
I mean, yeah, no, I think one of the things that really
do you like fighting
so
people with guns and rapiers?
She was a nerd. Like, the second I found out she plays tabletop,
D&D,
like plays tabletop with her friends, like Navia, and I was like, that's crazy, because yeah. I walked in and everyone on the call was like, hey, so I don't know if you know about tabletop or like
shut up,
you know, certain games involving tabletop. And I was yeah. like, are you kidding me? I live for that stuff. It's I love it so much. And so to be able to bring that side to her was just so incredibly
E&D
fun.
Rep,
and I love connecting with how much she like, she's secretly super, super friendly. Like, you don't
yeah.
expect it when you meet her. She's, like, super stoic and, like,
yeah.
down to business. But secretly, she's just out here loving her friends and, like, supporting people. And, yeah, I don't know. I loved that aspect of her. She just felt, she really came alive when I found that much more about her personal life beyond
yes.
her role in the court. It was so much fun. And
that's so
yeah,
cute. I love
her
that.
So much. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Well, it's been so great to hear from all these different actors. I've loved this. This is great.
This is so really fun.
Wow.
I know. I love hearing about how everyone connected, like, personally. It's like that little backstage glimpse that you don't usually get.
Yes. A little peek behind the curtain, if you will.
Exactly. Yes. And I still can't believe it's been 4 years. I feel like no time at all has passed somehow. Like, and also all the time has passed.
Like, it's so surreal. It really
meaningless.
Is.
Who knows?
Well,
oh my gosh.
I mean,
well, this has been great. I've had so much fun with y'all today.
Same.
I loved that.
And I can't wait for the next.
Looking
so,
for
I
voice
mean,
actor
hey,
who works at a funeral parlor.
And happy anniversary, travelers.
Yes.
Yay. Thank
anniversary.
You, girls.
Woo.
Bye. Bye. Risley and Sino. Oh my god, Alejandro.
Hello, everybody. This is Alejandro Saab, voice of Sino. And thanks for tuning in to Tevet Talks.
Hello, Joe.
Hey, everyone. Joe Zija, voice of Risley here.
I see your ads for your voice acting course all the time.
Yeah, same. Dude, I can't believe it's been 4 years. Oh my gosh. I remember when the game first started and I was like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And now I'm like, I know a little bit of what I'm doing.
Yeah, I don't think I've even reached a little bit. I think like when I stream the game, it's mostly entertaining because I don't know what I'm doing at all. It's been awesome to get to know the fan base and the game, and it's just this Genshin Impact has become this whole massive world. Like, who could have imagined?
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, so I totally get it. So, without further delay, let's check out what our voice actors have to say about this landmark occasion in our journey.
Hi, oh my god, Aaron!
The English voice of the Knave, aka Arlecchino. Oh,
and
AKA
also
Father.
Obsidian.
We've recorded many Arlecchino
because
scenes over the years that
you
I
really
am
like
really quite fond
black,
of,
white, and red.
The ones that I recall most warmly are those that explore.
Sorry to crash into
more
easily. Have a great night.
Chilly tenderness, mwah. Particularly in those few intimate moments with her children or with Clairvy. I knew we made something special while in the booth, but oh boy. Watching the finished sequences with all the other actors' performances in there instantly made me so proud to be a part of this cast. And yes, it's also quite fun to play her viciously cool and aloof yet badass sides too. So thank you all for letting me be a small piece of this huge narrative adventure.
Thank you, Aaron.
Such an incredible and welcoming community. Congrats on 4 amazing years, Genshin. Here's to many more.
Yay, thank you.
Man, Arlecchino was so cool, and I absolutely adored that story. It was dark, and it was just sad at times. But you know, a lot of work goes into building the voices for these characters, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes like you don't know what the work's going to be until you get there. One of my favorite lines of Risley's is, if the Duke wants somebody dead, he needs no justification. And a lot of people don't know that it's one of the first scenes we ever did in the booth. And I remember thinking like, whoa, this guy's like, rough. He's a prison warden. He's over here saying he's above the law. Okay, I guess, you know, we'll play him tough, right? We'll play him really rough. And then it turned out that he was this really intelligent, respectable, even like kind man. Yeah. And so I just had to take that toughness that was, you know, kind of right out the gate and then apply it to his otherwise really formal language. He speaks really intelligently. But he's also got this kind of like blue collar spirit that makes for a super interesting mix. It was just one of those fun experiments in character development on the fly.
Yeah, yeah. Moments like that are absolutely awesome, especially when portraying these characters that have so many layers and so many dimensions. I mean, in Sino's second story, we got to see so many layers of Sino, you know. We're so used to him being nice to his friends after so many patches in Genshin Impact, you know. Like, he's like, oh, let's play Genius Invocation TCG. Here's a random joke. But it's cool that we finally got to, you know, a nice reminder that he's still the general Mahamantra.
Yep.
Yeah, and it, like, all of us have our own
Sino's pretty sick,
little
dude.
Stories about how we came to it. And like,
you know,
really neat,
Japanese
so.
Voice actress sounds very severe. I don't think I've heard her. I might have played in Japanese
First
once.
Of all, congratulations on 4 years, you cute people.
I used to play
and
a lot
wow,
more in Japanese.
I have been part of the incredible Genshin Impact universe.
But now I have to switch
exactly
it to English requests
now.
And stuff.
And let me just
I just forget
say,
to switch it back.
I was instantly hooked. From the talented team at MiHoYo.
Hate that
Ryo's
smart. Like, it's not justifying my hatred for him,
Studio
right?
Ryo and the players around the globe. There is
he
such an incredible energy tying us all together. When we started our records and I dove into Navia's emotional roller coaster of a backstory, I knew that this game was something special. I mean,
Malus and Silver still make me tear up just thinking about them.
Oh, man. Silver and Malus. I miss those guys. They were so cool. They were funny, but... Man, good times.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet him. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet, so... before we get any spoilers, let's hear from Amber and Stephanie.
Yeah.
Congratulations on the 4-year anniversary.
Joe just
this
got spoiled.
Year the most exciting thing
Rip.
Because I get to be a part of a game that transcends not only story and beauty, but also a great community of players. Emily was such a fun character to play. She's calm during stressful or terrifying situations, yet gentle when it's called for. She can read the room and sniff problems out pretty quickly, too. I knew she had to be mature enough to have the smarts.
She, her, she's one of the ones that, like, her voices
impressed me every day in the studio. When I found out which character
almost more childlike in real life.
I was on a break in the studio, and the engineer told me Emily was the main character for this update. Initially, I didn't understand. But then once we recorded more and more, it hit me. I am now part of the Genshin Impact family, which is pretty awesome.
She's so cute, stop.
It's a true honor. Thank you for having me.
I still can't believe I've been in the game for nearly 4 years. It's wild to think that I started as Cloud Retainer the
Her eyes look so like...
I am so proud of getting to play her.
In the chibi form.
Not only is she a character that has helped me stretch my own vocal range, but she's also so full of life and
mystery. They're so large.
And so unintentionally hilarious. I started playing her as the mysterious and not so kind Adeptus, as we all know. And every time
I started playing her when she was just an NPC bird,
I get to give insight into other beloved characters through some pretty funny quips or some deeply sad backstories. So when I was asked
Shen-he.
For her life as the playable Shenyun, one was over the moon. I mean, with her human form, I would be able to share her softer side, the side that we've only had glimpses of. So one was really, loving getting to play the funny, soft, strong, intelligent, sassy, and loving character that she is.
She really is so good.
I mean, she is the type of character that has made Genshin Impact so special for so many people throughout the years. So thank you so much for asking me to be her, and happy 4-year anniversary, Genshin Impact.
Aw. That, man, I'm a nerd for this game. I love Genshin Impact, and just hearing so many
Me
people
too,
and all of the actors in this cast just be so excited about it. I'm not gonna lie, it made me tear up a little, and I know that folks are gonna be like, no, you didn't, and I'm like, man, it just
let
makes
the,
my heart all
let
warm.
Let the man cry. Like, I feel a little bit. One of the things, like, the
let the man cry
is how
when she called Ganyu plump and exposed that she rolled down hills. Yeah.
Any story, really. And all we're hearing from actors is that how it evolved, right? Like, no one knows what shape it's going to take. You just release this thing into the world, and then the collaborative efforts of all these people kind of morph and change. And it's developed so organically. It's really, really cool. Like a living, breathing organism, but it's just art.
Yeah. And I'm just so honored that I get to be a part of this, of the English cast, with you and everybody else.
Yeah.
Well, everyone, that's a wrap on Teyvat Talks. Thanks for tuning in.
These 4 years of Genshin Impact have been amazing, and the adventure continues on.
Thanks, guys. Yay! Oh, that was so good. I love when they do that. Whoa, no, I don't want to watch Five Nights at Freddy's. No, thank you. I'm good. Oh, that's it. That's the end. It's over. 7 freaking years later. Oh my gosh. Oh, I should have been taking notes. I don't even like know what I just witnessed. Like, I don't even know what just happened. Spirited, thank you for the water. I was literally reaching for it. You read my mind. Like, so much was just discussed and said, and I'm genuinely so excited for it all. It looks beautiful. That's a lot of QOL. That's a lot of they know what they're doing. They're picking it up and they're cooking.
I'm so excited. We have 12 days, I think. 12 days until it comes out. Less than 2 weeks. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I'm so excited. What are your guys' thoughts? What was your favorite part of it? I don't even, like... I think something that I'm definitely really intrigued about is the whole, like, Night Soul thing and how it almost seems like there's, like, a... like, an upside-down kind of vibe. Like a different version of the Natlin that we know. That's kind of what it felt like. And I'm very intrigued about it. It was very... very mysterious.